So good afternoon, everyone. This is your RB3 batch, no? Okay. So today we'll be starting international relations. And first of all, tell me how many of you are writing prelims this time? Almost all. No, there might be some who might be appearing there, because in some batches there are students who are in the second year or final year of graduation. Do we have someone like this here? Who is an undergraduate? Class 12? Good. Good. At least 12th tak to hai. 6th, 7th nahi hai. Have you seen, Fitji is there, no? Fitji? If you go to tier 2 towns, so they have programs 5th standards onward for IIT, theek hai? Ellen also, foundation or something, I don't know what kind of teaching. So, okay, IR, how are we preparing for international relations? Most of us are writing PT this time, hai na? So, otherwise also, how are we preparing for IR? Kaise kar rahe? Newspapers, current affairs or whatever current material from any institute, either udhar jahan se bhi kar rahe ho, that is the only source that you are doing, either newspapers or the material that you have. What about some basic things? Kaise, how are you covering? No need to prepare basic. UPSC current pooch raha hai, huh? UPSC current pooch raha hai, so no need to prepare basic. And I think in the new notification UPSC has written, no, we will never ask the basics. Likha hai kahin? Likha hai? So, and this is Unpredictable Service Commission UPSC, so so the thing is, at least a little bit of basic, because whatever is happening in the current scenario, there is a basic to it. When we are saying India is giving asymmetrical support, so you should be knowing what is the history of this asymmetrical support. When we are when we are discussing whether NAM should be there or not, so what is the basic of NAM? At least the bare minimum basic we need to study. I am not saying you read mota mota books. We are not here for a graduation course of IR. We are here to clear the UPSC exam. But nowhere it is written. And the way UPSC is asking you questions, okay, IR, if you see, it is gaining lots of importance. In prelims also, last time, how many questions? Approximately 12 questions. You might categorize them as, okay, Golan Heights hai toh geography mein pooch liya kahan hai. You might take it as a geography thing. But otherwise, the place was in news because of IR. So they are interlinking the things. Similarly, in your mains also, 4 questions in paper 2. But this time, South China Sea was there in paper 1. And geography teacher never teaches you South China Sea. Okay? And then Indus Water Treaty in paper 3. Ecology environment teacher will not teach you Indus Water Treaty. So the thing how IR, UPSC is integrating with other subjects. So IR is gaining importance. If it is economics, WTO question in economics, they might ask you about your service industry. They might ask you. Okay? So IR of late, don't think only 4 or 3 questions in paper 3. If you start analyzing the things, you will understand the importance, growing importance of IR. And the way world is moving, IR is definitely a era. Okay, whether it is UPSC or whether it is a private sector. And then it comes to your interviews also, your personality test. Dho-dho-ke question poochte hai IR ke. Okay? And there is no separate preparation for UPSC prelims. If prelims ho jayega, toh mains ka karenge. Mains ho jayega, toh interview ka karenge. It has to be a integrated approach. But then, time. Right now, we are in the mid of April. So, PT is approaching, so we'll focus more on PT. Once PT is clear, then we will focus more on mains. But the thing is, whenever you are preparing, it should be a holistic preparation. Otherwise, if you are preparing in silos, just clearing PT will not help you. Just clearing mains will not help you. Unless until you get good marks in your interviews also, because rank nahi to piche aa jati hai. Everyone wants to go for first 2-3 services, not your group B services, hai na? Andaman, Nicobar, administrative service or something. Okay? Nothing to laugh at. Getting the name in the list itself is a big achievement. But the thing is, when we are dreaming high, so that should be your preparation, whether it is IR, history, geography, whatever. It should be an integrated approach. Okay? Now, what is the syllabus of IR in UPSC? UPSC has given you some syllabus for IR. क्या जरूरत है लिखता है देखेंगे IR है ना मतलब क्वेश्चन आएगा वी विल राइट इट वाई बॉदर टू रीड द सिलेबस यूपीएससी इज अ फूल हु इज राइटिंग 2-3 लाइन्स अबाउट एनी सिलेबस है ना सी अनदर थिंग It's not only applicable for your IR, but for each and every subject that UPSC is asking. UPSC never goes beyond its syllabus. That should be the golden rule, which should be implemented in your minds, that UPSC never goes beyond the syllabus. But we don't read the syllabus, so we think, yaar, is baar to pattern hi change kar diya. Syllabus to padho. Kahan pattern change kiya hai? Usi ke around pucha hai. ठीक है इवन फॉर आई आर यू पी एस सी हैज़ डिवोटेड टाइम टू राइट 4 लाइन्स एंड यू पीपल आर गिविंग प्राइम ऑफ योर यूथ टू यू पी एस सी बट वी डोंट बॉदर टू रीड द सिलेबस दिस इज समथिंग इज नॉट एक्सपेक्टेड हाँ प्लीज़ पढ़ लिया करो सिलेबस यू पी एस सी सिलेबस फॉर योर आई आर इट टॉक्स अबाउट नंबर वन आई रीड इट आउट फॉर यू इट टॉक्स अबाउट इंडिया एंड इट्स नेबरहुड डैश रिलेशंस So if you see, every year, they are asking you questions. Last year it was India-Pakistan. This year also they have asked you about SAARC nations. So they keep on asking you questions like this. Okay? Second line says bilateral, regional, global groupings and agreements involving India and or affecting India's interests. Okay? So they are asking you, bilateral regional global groupings SAARC is one regional grouping BIMSTEC is a regional grouping they are asking you questions in your prelims also based on this organizations we say they ask about organizations it is very much written there regional groupings they will be asking bilateral groupings they will be they are asking you Mekong Ganga organization what is this MG Mekong MGO ठीक है मेकोंग गंगा सॉरी एमजीसी मेकोंग गंगा कोऑपरेशन सो इट्स नॉट आउट ऑफ समवेयर दे आर आस्किंग यू इट इज वेरी मच देयर इन द सिलेबस बट वी डोंट बॉदर टू रीड इट ठीक है देन थर्ड लाइन सेज अफेक्ट ऑफ डेवलपिंग एंड इफेक्ट ऑफ पॉलिसीज एंड पॉलिटिक्स ऑफ डेवलप्ड एंड डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज ऑन इंडियाज इंटरेस्ट्स ठीक है अफेक्ट ऑफ पॉलिसीज एंड पॉलिटिक्स ऑफ डेवलप्ड एंड डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज ऑन इंडियाज इंटरेस्ट सो डेवलप एंड डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज वी आर फाइटिंग इन WTO एवरी टाइम दे आर आस्किंग यू क्वेश्चंस वेदर इट इज PT दे हैव आस्क्ड यू पीस क्लॉज पूछा है दे हैव आस्क्ड यू AOA एग्रीमेंट ऑन एग्रीकल्चर दे हैव आस्क्ड यू अबाउट योर इंटरनेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस लाइक UNSC रिफॉर्म्स लास्ट ईयर दे हैव आस्क्ड यू पूछा है उन्होंने They asked you Doha this time. So what is this? This is in your syllabus. It's not that they are asking from anywhere. Then it talks about Indian diaspora. A separate topic is given. Diaspora. So they ask you questions in prelims about Pravasi Bharatiya Divas. They ask you questions in mains about diaspora policies, challenges and all those things. Okay? Then important international institutions, agencies and fora, their structure and mandate. ठीक है NSG, UNSC, all those things come under this. In prelims, they are asking you. Last time, they asked you about Vasenaar agreement. ठीक है Important international institutions, groupings, or some, what is Vasenaar agreement? What is Australia group? The things, it is very much given here. And they are asking you. This, if you see the syllabus, nothing is beyond the syllabus, either in your prelims or in your mains. ठीक है, एवरीथिंग इज देयर, बट हम मेहनत नहीं करते हैं. हाँ, वी जस्ट लिसन टू व्हाट आर सीनियर्स से और कौन क्या कर रहा है, वी आर जस्ट बॉदर्ड अबाउट दैट. तुमने ये पढ़ा, मैं भी पढ़ लूँ. अरे भैया सिलेबस पढ़ो. एंड द पीपल हु आर रीडिंग सिलेबस, दे रिमेन फोकस्ड, एंड द पीपल फ्रॉम स्मॉल स्मॉल विलेजेस आर गेटिंग थ्रू. You might have, if you see overall, UPSC gives you everything. UPSC gives you question papers, previous year question papers, to see what is that trend. UPSC is providing you syllabus. UPSC every year comes out with its one analysis also. So go and see it. Which age group is clearing? People from which strata is clearing? People from which tier cities are clearing? Pura analysis aata hai. ठीक है, बजाय इधर उधर व्हाट राजेंद्र नगर मुखर्जी नगर पीपल आर टॉकिंग ओवर द कप ऑफ टी, जस्ट गो थ्रू दैट, दैट विल गिव यू एन इनसाइट. ठीक है, ओके. नाउ इफ यू सी मटेरियल एंड बुक फॉर यूपीएससी, सॉरी फॉर इंटरनेशनल रिलेशंस, देयर आर सो मेनी बुक्स इन द मार्केट फॉर द बेसिक. ठीक है, वी एन खन्ना इज देयर, सीकरी इज देयर, नाम सुना होगा इन सब का. हाँ, वी एन खन्ना, हर्ष वी पंत, सीकरी, there are so many books. So I would not suggest you one or the other book. I would suggest if you want to go through any of these books, go to the bookshop, ask the shopkeeper to give you the 3-4 books. Go through the books in whichever book you are comfortable at. ठीक है, जिसको पढ़ के समझ में आ रहा हो सकता है. आई माइट बी कम्फर्टेबल रीडिंग हर्ष वी पंत, यू माइट बी कम्फर्टेबल रीडिंग सीकरी. ठीक है, जिसमें भी आप कंफर्टेबल हो वो बुक लो. ये नहीं कि मार्केट में चल कौन सी रही है, चल जो रही है अगर मुझे समझ ही नहीं आए तो मेरे लिए क्या फ़ायदा है उसका. दिस शुड बी योर फिलॉसफी फॉर योर बाइंग ऑफ बुक्स, बिकॉज देयर आर एन नंबर ऑफ बुक्स. यू सी विच वन फंडामेंटल बेसिक स्टैंडर्ड बुक एंड देन विच एवर यू आर कंफर्टेबल एट, यू कैन बाय दैट इफ यू वॉन्ट. अदरवाइज वी हैव आर एनसीईआरटीज. ठीक है, एनसीईआरटी आई थिंक इट्स मोर देन एनफ टू कवर योर आईआर पोर्शन. हैव वी कम अक्रॉस एनीथिंग विद रिस्पेक्ट टू आईआर इन एनसीईआरटीज? वेयर? यस, विच क्लास 12th पॉलिटी बुक्स, दे कवर योर बेसिक आईआर. ठीक है, फर्स्ट थिंग इज योर वर्ल्ड हिस्ट्री. यू हैव वर्ल्ड हिस्ट्री बुक एटलीस्ट यूएन एंड ऑनवर्ड्स, कोल्ड वॉर एरा, यूएन एंड ऑनवर्ड्स, रीड दैट. दैट गिव्स यू सम काइंड ऑफ बेसिक आइडिया अबाउट हाउ द वर्ल्ड हैज़ मूव्ड आफ्टर योर सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर. ठीक है, थोड़ा सा हिस्ट्री आपको अगर आता है वर्ल्ड हिस्ट्री में, इफ़ यू हैव सम इंटरेस्ट प्लीज रीड इट. दैट विल गिव यू एन आइडिया, बिकॉज इन इंटरनेशनल रिलेशंस वॉट इज देयर, नथिंग इज, ओनली 3 थिंग्स यू शुड बी नोइंग इफ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट यूएन. ठीक है, जैसे हमारा सिलेबस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट इंटरनेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस, इफ इट इज सेइंग यूएन, से फॉर एग्जाम्पल वॉट इज द हिस्ट्री ऑफ यूएन, यू शुड बी नोइंग दैट. ठीक है, वॉट इज द प्रेजेंट क्राइसिस दैट इज गोइंग ऑन, because UN may be are saying UNSC position this, then present crisis is based on the historical makeup of UN, so you should be knowing and what should be the future course of action. Say for example India Bangladesh relationship, what was the history of this relationship, what is the current thing that is going on, and what could be the future of this relationship. This is what is your basic. Kabhi bhi whenever you read any topic in IR, always try to link it with the history, find out the history of that thing, current analysis and future. That's your whole topic gets completed. So you can read any of these books, then you can write NCERTs, you can politics in India since independence. Politics in India since independence. Chapter 4. It talks about India's external relations. India's external relations. ठीक है, then we have contemporary world politics. Contemporary world politics. In this book we have 9 chapters. 1 to 6 are related to your international relations. Chapter 1 to 6. First it talks about Cold War. ठीक है, second it talks about bipolarity, it talks about US hegemony, then alternative centers of power, contemporary South Asia and international organizations. The first six chapters are dedicated for your IR. Okay? The basic things you can do, and apart from that, everyone has the access right now. We have information overload. Okay? So there also you need to see what to read and what not to read. It's always keep in mind when we are reading IR here, here means in the GS, it is only that level of IR required. Okay? Out of curiosity, it's very good if you are interested in, say, for example, what is happening in now Korean Peninsula right now. Okay? American Armada is coming and Russia and all, everyone is sending. China is also sending the fleet. So you just, out of curiosity, that is one thing. Okay? That, keep that for your interview thing. But right now, only prepare as much as is required as per the exam. ठीक है, बहुत ज़्यादा इसमें ग्रेजुएशन लेवल का आपको नहीं पढ़ना है, आपको उतना पढ़ना है एज द सिलेबस सेज दैट व्हाट अ वेल इन्फॉर्म्ड पर्सन शुड नो. इट क्लियरली सेज, सिलेबस क्लियरली सेज जीएस व्हाट अ वेल इन्फॉर्म्ड पर्सन शुड नो. ठीक है, तो उतना यू कैन रीड. सो रीड फ्रॉम, अपार्ट फ्रॉम द बेसिक एनसीईआरटीज, यू कैन गो थ्रू द करेंट थिंग्स, इवन इन न्यूज़पेपर्स, सो मेनी आर्टिकल्स, यू हैव टू सी हुज़ आर्टिकल टू रीड. किसका पढ़ना है आर्टिकल? सी राजा मोहन इज देयर, देन एम के नारायण इज देयर. सी द पीपल हु हैव सम सेइंग इन द इंटरनेशनल पॉलिटिक्स. इट्स नॉट दैट सम पॉलिटिकल लीडर फ्रॉम द करंट पार्टी इज सेइंग समथिंग और द करंट अपोजिशन लीडर इज सेइंग समथिंग. यू कैन रीड दैट बट यू कैन नॉट, बिकॉज दे हैव वन bent of mind, है ना, biasness होती है. तो we need to read good articles and at the same time, even like say, for example, you have read C. Raja Mohan's article. He might be giving his view, ठीक है. Then alternatively, there can be N. K. Narayan's article. He might be giving his own view. So you need to see and how to take out 4-5 positives, 4-5 negatives, because you get questions like critically analyze. ठीक है, चार पांच उनके पॉइंट्स पॉजिटिव, चार पांच नेगेटिव. यू नीड टू प्रिपेयर योर नोट्स लाइक दैट. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, इन द क्लास वील ट्राई टू कवर एज मच, आई ऑलवेज ट्राई टू कवर एज मच करंट एज वी कैन. इवन फ्रॉम टुडेज पेपर, इफ समथिंग इज करंट, आई ट्राई टू इंक्लूड इन माई क्लास नोट्स. बट दिस सब्जेक्ट इज सो डायनेमिक. मॉर्निंग यू हैव वन डिसीजन, आफ्टरनून इट इज चेंज्ड. ठीक है, अभी राइट नाउ द अर्माडा इज कमिंग, चाइना एंड रशिया इज देयर. इन द इवनिंग यू डोंट नो व्हाट इज गोइंग टू बी द फाइनल आउटकम इन योर कोरियन पेनिनसुला. सो इट इज सो डायनेमिक, यू नीड टू अपडेट योर सिलेबस एवरी टाइम. ठीक है, ओके. नाउ व्हाट इज फॉरेन पॉलिसी? वी हैव टॉक्ड सो मच इंटरनेशनल. अच्छा, फर्स्ट व्हाट इज इंटरनेशनल रिलेशंस? What do you understand by international relation? International relations. Yes, come on. In my class, I want two-way communication. Okay? The international relation is what? Relationship with another international. Say, for example, this is one state. This is another state. So, this is international relationship, inter and national. Within different nations, the relationship, that is your international relations. Okay? But this is just a traditional definition. Don't you find it a traditional definition? Because right now, even as your syllabus in IR says, thoda sa dimag lagao, syllabus says that bilateral groupings, it talks about international different platforms. Okay? So right now, if you see, governments are not only interacting with one country or another country. Governments are also, say for example, India is also interacting with WTO, with UN, with NSG. NSG is not a government, WTO is not a government, but it's a platform. ठीक है, सो दैट ऑल्सो कम्स अंडर योर इंटरनेशनल रिलेशंस, इजेंट इट? देन मीन्स स्टेट टू स्टेट वी आर इंटरैक्टिंग, एट द सेम टाइम वी आर ऑल्सो इंटरैक्टिंग विद इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस. ठीक है, सिमिलरली गवर्नमेंट्स आर ऑल्सो इंटरैक्टिंग विद मैनी नॉन स्टेट एक्टर्स, नॉन स्टेट एक्टर्स और सिविल सोसाइटीज. से फॉर एग्जाम्पल वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम, वी ऑल हैव हर्ड अबाउट वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम. एवरी ईयर जनवरी मंथ इट टेक्स प्लेस एट डेवोस. तो वट इज दिस वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम? इज वॉट? इट्स अ नॉन प्रॉफिट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन स्विट्जरलैंड. सो आवर गवर्नमेंट, आवर रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स आर गोइंग देयर. ठीक है, वी आर ऑल्सो इंटरैक्टिंग विद वेरियस मल्टी नेशनल एन जी ओज, वी आर इंटरैक्टिंग विद दैम, वी आर इंटरैक्टिंग विद एमनेस्टी ऑल्सो, वी आर इंटरैक्टिंग विद ग्रीन पीस ऑल्सो, वी आर इंटरैक्टिंग विद ट्रांसपेरेंसी ऑल्सो, ट्रांसपेरेंसी इंटरनेशनल. सो दैट इज वाई दिस डेफिनेशन ऑफ स्टेट इंटर रिलेशन बिटवीन वन कंट्री एंड अनदर कंट्री इज अ ट्रेडिशनल डेफिनेशन. द करेंट सिनारियो वी call it by the name of global politics. That is why it is, you might have read in the newspapers, at times the term uses global politics. Global politics means the countries are not only interacting with each other but also with international organizations and other non-state actors, your civil societies and all. So the new terminology that is being used on the international platform is your global politics. Theek hai, samajh mein aaya? See, this first class we are going to deal with the basic things, because on this might not be your direct questions, but these are the things which make your fundamentals. So first class is the fundamental class. Theek hai? Now what is a foreign policy? Yes, what? Yes, you are right. Mm-hmm. Yes, the way a country has to deal with other country, yes, that is foreign policy. What is foreign policy? See, basically a very simple definition. Always try to get into the simple definitions, because जब आप इंटरव्यू तक पहुंचते हो, और इंशाल्लाह आप सब पहुंचे हो वहां तक, जब आप इंटरव्यू तक पहुंचते, व्हेन यू रीच्ड इन इंटरव्यू, दे आस्क यू वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चंस. व्हाट इज अ फॉरेन पॉलिसी? डू यू थिंक इंडियाज फॉरेन पॉलिसी इज डूइंग गुड? दे बिल्ट अप द थिंग्स. दे डोंट आस्क यू डायरेक्टली, दे विल आस्क यू व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड बाय फॉरेन पॉलिसी. ओके, दिस सर, दिस इज फॉरेन. ओके, डू यू थिंक इट इज डूइंग गुड? व्हाट काइंड ऑफ रिफॉर्म्स कुड बी ब्रॉट? So these basic things. So whenever you are preparing any definition, in spite of the subject that you are preparing for, right, go for as simple as possible. Okay? So foreign policy is what? Foreign policy is a plan of action. You can write it down. Plan of action adopted by one nation. Plan of action adopted by one nation in regard to its diplomatic dealings with another country / international organization / non-state actor, etc. ठीक है, इट इज अ सिस्टमैटिक वे हाउ अ कंट्री इज डीलिंग ऑन द ग्लोबल प्लेटफॉर्म ऑन वेरियस इश्यूज, हाउ अ कंट्री इज इंटरैक्टिंग विद द वेरियस इंस्टीट्यूशन, दैट इज योर फॉरेन पॉलिसी. ठीक है, नाउ व्हाट आर द मेन डिटर्मिनेंट्स ऑफ अ फॉरेन पॉलिसी? व्हाट आर द मेन डिटर्मिनेंट्स ऑफ अ फॉरेन पॉलिसी? एनी फॉरेन पॉलिसी इज बेस्ड ऑन सम थिंग्स. ठीक है, सो देयर माइट बी सर्टन determinants which determine that this should be our foreign policy. Yes, first and the foremost is your national interest. Okay, one is your national interest. Other things, Mutual cooperation, okay. What else? Be loud. International harmony, okay. Determinants, which determines factors. See, national international harmony and all those are your goals. You try to achieve that through your foreign policy. But what are the defining pillars? Internal politics, ideology of the nation, yes. Anything else? Economic interest, okay. That helps to build your foreign policy, hai na? Ki how much is the comfort, okay. What all subjects have been covered in your batch? History ho gaya, geography ho gaya, economics ho gaya, polity ho gaya, culture ho gaya, okay. Society has also been done. Everything is the determinant of your foreign policy. ठीक है, first, depending on your geography, your foreign policies, your marine policy, your all those things, one by one we'll deal. The first and the foremost determinant of a foreign policy is your national interest. ठीक है, the first and the foremost determinant is your national interest. And what comprises your national interest? National interest comprises the sovereignty of your country. No foreign policy will ever compromise on your sovereignty. ठीक है, territorial integrity. Can we compromise on our territorial integrity? No, we cannot compromise on our territorial integrity. So you can write these points if you want, if you know, very good. Then what is your national interest? National interest is the core interest which cannot be compromised. And national interests are also of two types. National interest, one is your core and one is your temporary. ठीक है, core includes your sovereignty of a nation. It includes your geographical integrity. Promotion of trade. Protection of your people. We cannot make a foreign policy compromising on the security of your people. Hai na? So these are the core pillars of your national interest. Now, what is your temporary national interest? Can you give me some example? National interest, temporary. Trade. See, example of temporary could be, say for example, voting pattern in UN. At times, say for example, your Iran issue. ठीक है, we had a good relationship with Iran when we were going for sanctions. Then we voted for sanctions in Iran, temporary. Why? Because that time we were bargaining with US for nuclear power. Similarly, with respect to your Sri Lanka, war crimes are happening there. ठीक है, पढ़ा है ना, war crime tribunals and all those things. We will do it whenever we will be covering Sri Lanka thing. But yes, many times we have voted in favor, many times we have abstained, many times we have voted against. Same country taking different stands at different times, depending on the need of the hour. So that is your temporary national interest. Okay? So first and the foremost thing is your national interest. Then it also depends on the time during which it is conducted. Time during which it is conducted. Say for example, what was our policy during Cold War era and what is our policy today? There is a lot of difference. What was the policy immediately after independence and what is the policy down in 2000s and what is the policy right now? It also depends on the time during which it is conducted. Then it also depends on your geography. How is your geography? Geography, your maritime boundaries, your Himalayan boundaries. Okay, that is one aspect. Apart from that, if you see, now we are not having uranium. Uranium is a resource which is present in some other geography. Rare earth elements, these are the resource which is present in some other geography. So based on that, we make our MOUs, we sign relationship between different countries. So geography is also, how much is your land boundary, how much is your maritime boundary. These things also impact your foreign policy. Okay? Your history. How come history? There are certain concepts which historically, say for example, in India we are following, like the we are member of Commonwealth group. Then apart from that, the concept of buffer state. Buffer state, I hope, how many, dekho, another thing, if silliest of the thing you don't understand, please ask. Don't think what others will think. Don't think about that. Okay, it's good to be a fool for a day rather than fool to be a fool forever. Okay, forever means in UPSC. So if you are having any kind of doubt, please raise it. And still if you are not comfortable, after the class, please do ask. So there is a concept of buffer state. How many of us understand this concept? Buffer state kya hota hai, pata hai? You don't know? You know? Those who don't know buffer state? Because many times you might be reading in the newspapers about that Nepal is a buffer between India and China. Okay? We talk about these things. So when we read it, please try to find out when you are reading this in the newspaper, what is this concept of buffer state? Buffer state is basically, it's like a cushion state between two countries. What, like for example, between China and India we have Nepal. So that acts as a buffer zone, as a cushion. So that is basically your buffer state. So it also depends on your history. Like buffer state ka concept jo now we follow, ki we have to maintain a buffer. It was started during your British time only. Theek hai? Many times it is said that you might get a question like Indian foreign policy is a legacy of the Raj. Raj time pe jo tha, jaise Curzon's policy, they have asked you to compare policy of Nehru with Lord Curzon 10 years back. Theek hai? So this is what is how the things we are following from the historical time. That is also your, then your economy. Economy is now the major pillar of your foreign policy, determinant of foreign policy. How economy, depending on your economic interest, you are taking the steps. Say for example, what was our economy before LPG era? It was a closed economy, and then LPG we started, so we started looking towards east, look east policy. So this also depends on your economy during the time during which it is conducted. Then it also depends on the socio-cultural aspects. With respect to Nepal, we always read in the newspapers, Roti Beti Ka Rishta Hai. This term is being used. So what is this? Socio-economic relationship. What kind of relationship we have? Even in today's newspaper, you might have, if you have, you are reading Indian Express or Hindu. In Hindu only, I think I read. I read both the papers. So in Hindu only, it was written that the India's and Nepal's relationship is a very different relationship. It is based on people to people. It is based on our cultural and social heritage. Why the statement was given? Because right now, China and Nepal are doing the joint, first ever joint military exercise. What is the name of the exercise? Sagarmatha. Sagarmatha is the name of Nepalese word for Mount Everest. So that is why they are saying. So socio-cultural. Right now our Prime Minister is, anywhere he is going, he is talking about Buddhist circuit. development of Buddhist circuit. So what is this? This is your culture. Your culture also defines. Okay? Then ideology of a nation. Yes, ideology of a nation can be written as your political structure of a country. Your political structure of a country, it defines if there is a democracy, what will be the outcome. If it is your North Korea, see what is happening. If it is dictatorship, Assad, go to Syria, what kind of foreign policy. It also depends on the political setup of the country. Then it also depends on the personality of the leader. That time, Nehruvian, it is said, it is based on more of ideologies and ideal, it was said. Then your Indira Gandhi came, it is said like Nehru ki jo policies were more based on idealism, because he talked about non-aligned movement, he talked about having good relationship, equidistance, Panchsheel and all those things. But Indira Gandhi's era is called rear politic, because she divided Pakistan, hai na? Pakistan divide karke Bangladesh bana diya. So she has taken, then she integrated Sikkim into India. So these kind of things. So it also depends. And right now Modi is there. Now he is stressing too much on the diaspora. So it also depends on the leadership, personality of the leadership. And then at the same time, your public opinion also counts a major role in your foreign policy. Public opinion. Public opinion kaise karte hain? Brexit referendums are there, soft power is there, theek hai? Because your track to diplomacy, the word that we use, track to diplomacy. So this is what is your public opinion. So these are the main major determinants. There might be other determinants. Now I have used the term track to. How many of you are aware of this track one, track two? Shall I rub it? Track one, bolo pehle mita ke pooch rahe ho, shall I rub it? So I should have asked you before, okay. Because in the due course, we will be talking about, we should go for more of track two diplomacy. Okay, so what is this track one diplomacy? Track one. What is track one? Track one is your, say for example, this is state one and this is state two. So officials of one state interacting with officials, okay, canvassing going on, okay. Then what is track two? What is track two? Mm-hmm. Track two is your officials plus non-officials. No, this is track 1.5. Officials plus non-officials of one country interacting with officials and non-officials. This is called your track 1.5. Then track 2 is your, track 2 is your non-officials. I will explain non-officials interacting with your non-officials. And what is track 3? It is your people-to-people contact. See, track one is your, when officials of a country, say for example, Prime Minister interacting with Prime Minister, or you have your chief your national security advisor, official and official, okay? Of the two countries they are meeting. That is your track one diplomacy. Track two diplomacy is when your non-official, say for example, your civil societies, your FICCI business group, okay? Aapka FICCI ho gaya. from FICCI interacting with the same institution of Bangladesh. Recently it has happened when Begum Sheikh Hasina was here. So both the business chambers of both the countries, that is your example. So that is your non-officials with non-officials. That is your track two. Track 1.5 is your officials along with non-officials. They are interacting. That is your 1.5. And track 3 is your people to people, direct contact. That is your track 3. People to people contact is different from your non-official. Non-official is your civil society organization. But yeah, one-to-one, people to people contact. Example is your Border Hearts. We are running Border Hearts with Bangladesh and Myanmar. Even with Myanmar, we are running. Similarly, when we say with India and Pakistan, there should be more people-to-people contact. With respect to Nepal, we have people-to-people contact. You know, we have relationship in the families across the border. That is your people-to-people contact. That is your track three. Okay? So these are the basic terms. Still, if anyone has a doubt, that is, so officially he is interacting, no? Diaspora he is addressing, that is your basically aapka jo hai, formally he is interacting with the diaspora there. But it's not the diaspora group of India or the diaspora leader in India interacting with the diaspora leader of Bangladesh. So that is your track two. But yes, he is meeting them. So you can take it as a soft power. You can take it as a track two kind of a thing. But officially, he is addressing it. So ye jo aapka track one, track two, track three mein, it does not fit into that definition. Okay? Now, what is hard power, soft power? Because these are the terms we often use. Hard power, soft power, smart power, and fast power. These are the terms that we often encounter in the newspapers. So what is hard power? Okay. Example? Hard power is the power where we use force. Okay? Where we are using force against another country, where we are using coercion against another country, that is your hard power. So coercion can be military. We can go for military coercion or we can go for economic coercion like sanctions. We can go for sanctions against a country. That is a use of coercion, use of force. That is your hard power. Okay? Coercion or force, which could be your military or it can be your economic sanctions. Okay? Now, what is soft power? These are the components of soft power. Cultural exchange or Bollywood or cricket. These are the examples of soft power. But how will you... See, this is soft power is when you are persuading the other country to follow your footprint without use of force. When you are not using force, but you are trying to convince the other country to do what you want. That is your soft power. Samajh mein aaya? Nahi? Aaya? Nahi aaya? To poochho. Soft power is, see, hard power is, say for example, America. Okay? America, and take the example of America in Afghanistan. Okay? America has used force, everything in Afghanistan, so that Afghanistan should bend to what America wants. Got it? Then India, what was the role of India in Afghanistan? India did not participate in any kind of military attacks in Afghanistan, but we were doing so much of development work in Afghanistan, like we have built their parliament, dams, roads, schools, so many things we have done there. Now, without even use of force, Afghanistan is coming to India. We have not asked Afghanistan by using force, because it has seen that, yes, the people are following us, the people are helping us, so they are coming to India. So that you want Afghanistan to be in your fold. Okay, every country wants that other country should listen, but some use force and some use the other way around. Now, is it clear? Okay, so this is your soft power. When you are convincing the other country to follow your what you want without the use of force, that is your soft power. Now, what is smart power? Who has given the concept of soft power? Joseph Nye. Prelims is coming. Soft power. Joseph Nye. Joseph Nye has given the concept of soft power. Okay? Now, what is smart power? Prelims is coming. Soft power is the use of IT sector in diplomacy. Soft power, smart power is the product of soft and hard power. Smart power is your hard power plus soft power plus IT. I am asking you a question. अभी तो मैंने कुछ बताया ही नहीं इसके बारे में. I haven't see smart power. Don't get confused by the word IT here. It's not about IT. So smart power is equal to hard power plus soft power. This concept is also given by Joseph Nye. ठीक है, स्मार्ट पावर मीन्स यू आर यूजिंग बोथ काइंड्स ऑफ पावर टुगेदर. वन टाइम यू आर अटैकिंग ऑल्सो, एट द सेम टाइम यू आर डूइंग योर सॉफ्ट पावर थिंग ऑल्सो. सो दैट इज योर एंड लेटेस्ट, इफ यू आर अवेयर ऑफ द न्यू टर्मिनोलॉजीज, लेटेस्ट फॉर इंडिया द टर्म दैट इज, दिस इज ओनली फॉर इंडिया नाउ दे आर यूजिंग द टर्म इज योर फास्ट पावर. फास्ट पावर इज इंडिया इज यूजिंग इट्स सॉफ्ट पावर, सॉरी इंडिया इज यूजिंग इट्स स्मार्ट पावर वेरी प्रोएक्टिवली. सो दैट इज वाई दे आर यूजिंग दिस टर्म. नथिंग टू, मतलब यहाँ पे इन द आंसर्स यू डोंट नीड टू राइट, बट येस यू शुड बी, वेन यू आर रीडिंग न्यूज पेपर्स यू शुड बी अंडरस्टैंडिंग द टर्म्स दैट आर बींग यूज. ठीक है, सो वॉट इज योर फास्ट पावर? Especially with respect to India, they are using this term on international platforms, that we are using our smart power in a very proactive manner. If you see how vigorously we are in pursuing our foreign policy, in the last 3-4 years, Prime Minister has traveled to more than 47-48 countries. Okay? And similarly, all our people, all our senior officials, they are also being advised to travel to different small countries also. Why? To develop the relationship. So that is what is happening. Okay, now we are doing soft power. So just a few questions about that, and then this topic will be done. If in the exam you get a question like, okay, first let me tell you, I try to discuss the topics based on questions. First question, second question, third question, the whole topic will be covered in that. You might get a question like, what is soft power? What are the various components of India's soft power? Okay, that can be a question. Aise sub questions you get, what is soft power? Now you understand what is soft power. What are the various components of India's soft power? Other way you can get a question like, India is known for its soft power, should India stop investing in hard power? ठीक है, नहीं मुझे नो नहीं बोलो, वहाँ पे यू हैव टू राइट द आंसर मैक्सिमम 200 वर्ड्स, सो एटलीस्ट 160 वर्ड्स यू शुड बी हैविंग. ठीक है, यस और नो विल नॉट डू. वॉट आर द, सो शुड इंडिया स्टॉप इन इन्वेस्टिंग हार्ड पावर? नो, बट वन मतलब 150 वर्ड तो होने चाहिए ना. सो वॉट आर द लिमिटेशंस ऑफ अ सॉफ्ट पावर? दैट यू शुड बी नोइंग, देन ओनली यू कैन टॉक अबाउट कि वाई वी शुड नॉट गो फॉर ओनली सॉफ्ट पावर. ठीक है, ऐसे ही क्वेश्चन भी आते हैं. तो सॉफ्ट पावर आई थिंक इफ दिस वे इज ओके तो बताओ, अदरवाइज मतलब लंबा ऐसे लेक्चर टाइप करेंगे. क्वेश्चंस करें वैसा ठीक है. For all the topics, say for example, if we'll be taking one by one the principles, like we will be taking about NAM. ठीक है, NAM. Do you think NAM has a relevance? Critically analyze the relevance of NAM in India's foreign policy. Critically analyze the relevance of NAM as a group. So we will cover the holistic manner like that. ठीक है, I enjoy doing like that. But if you have some other way, you can always tell me. So what is soft power? We know. What are the components of India's soft power? Components are India. We are using developmental things also, and we are for example, many times we take hard measures also. Say for example, Maldives. ठीक है, when our Prime Minister 2015 he visited Indian Ocean Rim countries, he did not go to Maldives because the turmoil was going on there, no democracy was there, so we avoided Maldives. But at the same time 2014 we have done Operation Neer there. ठीक है, तो at times we also take stringent measures. ठीक है, डोंट कंपेयर आवर सेल्स कि हाउ वी हैव टेकन दिस मेजर विद विद से यूएसए, नॉट विद यूएसए, बट यस इन द नेबरिंग कंट्रीज वी एट टाइम्स बिकम वेरी हार्ड. यू हैव टू डू दिस, यू हैव टू कंप्लाई विद दिस, बट एट द सेम टाइम वी गो फॉर डेवलपमेंटल वर्क ऑल्सो. से फॉर एग्जाम्पल भूटान 2013 वी हैव स्टॉप्ड गिविंग देम योर पेट्रोलियम सब्सिडीज, एंड देन 5-year प्लान्स. We are funding their 5-year plans. Okay? So that is your examples. Now, what are the various components of India's soft power? Religion is one component. Apart from that, Bollywood, your dances, your cricket, inke alawa batao. Okay, awards, dance, drama, Bollywood, cuisine, cricket. These are the things we all know. Yes, international ethics, for example, can you give example? Our philosophies like Atithi Devo Bhavo, in United Nations also they are using these terms. Atithi Devo Bhavo, Vasudev Kutumbakam, these kind of things. Atithi Devo Bhavo, especially with respect to your refugee crisis. They are saying, don't shun away the refugees. Follow the philosophy of India. We are having so many refugees here. Atithi Devo Bhavo, Vasudev Kutumbakam. We talk about Vasudev Kutumbakam, the whole world is a family. This is being discussed. Then apart from that, your space diplomacy, that is a soft power. Space diplomacy. Abhi, we have launched 104 satellites. We are sharing the data with many developing countries, say for example with Bhutan, with Nepal, Bangladesh. So this is also your soft power. Okay? Then our non-violent freedom struggle, India's non-violent freedom struggle, which is being discussed everywhere, that is also your soft power. ठीक है, your Ayush, Ayush, what is that? Ayurveda, Yoga, Yunani, Siddha and Homeopathy, that is your soft power. Then we are giving line of credit, what is that? That is your soft power, lines of credit. योगा बोला, आयुष में कर दिया. मेडिकल टूरिज्म, ऑल दोज थिंग्स, दीज योर सर्विस सेक्टर, योर सॉफ्ट पावर. तो दिस इज ऑल इज योर सॉफ्ट पावर. ठीक है, व्हाट इज सॉफ्ट पावर, व्हाट आर द कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ इंडिया सॉफ्ट पावर, देन कम्स योर should India stop investing in soft power? No, India should not stop investing, in hard power. Should India stop? No, India should not stop. So why India should not stop? Because there are certain challenges to soft power. What are the challenges to soft power? Tit for tat kaise matlab? So what are the limitations of soft power? Number one, if the kind of threat perception that we have in our surrounding right now, theek hai, Pakistan is a nuclear state, theek hai? See the turmoil going on in Afghanistan, then China is also a nuclear state. If they are attacking us, say Pakistan is attacking us with a nuclear bomb, can we rely, okay, 20 saal tak we'll do the soft power, can we do that? No, because number one, the threat perception because of the nuclear power states that we have, we cannot totally rely on soft power. That is your number one thing, okay? Then soft power is something which is time taking. It will not happen in a day. It's a very long process. It's a very, very long process. It's not that in a day things will happen, okay? It takes time, soft power. Then number three, in a country like India, which has resource crunch, we cannot totally give everything to soft power. No? There also comes a limitation. For soft power, we don't have that much of resources. We have resource limitation. That also needs to be taken. Then many times, our soft power approach is taken by our neighbors in a very negative manner. They say, by doing this, we are interfering in their internal politics. Big brother word suna hai? Big brother and elder brother, these two words we often read in the newspapers. Big brother, brother and elder brother. Those who know, very good. Those who don't know, big brother is someone who is bullying. Jo aapko bahut kadak hoga, theek hai? The big brother means who is bullying, who is not caring, who is bullying all the time. And elder brother is someone who cares about you. So that is your elder brother. So many times, countries like Nepal, Bhutan, they always say that India is using the soft power because India wants to get into our internal affairs, and then they start behaving like big brother. So that is also one of the limitations, because, and then above all, soft power has no value without hard power. Okay? It's a reality in life. Say for example, if today USA tells us something, we will listen to it, okay? And at the same time, if Saint Lucia tells us something, will we listen? Will we listen to that? If US will tell us something, we will comply. Even in normal life also, when you are just going somewhere, your father is saying something, you will listen to it. If some stranger is telling you something, you will say, oh, first look at yourself, don't give me advice. Okay? So that is, it's a reality. In international politics, soft power is more successful when it is with hard power. So that is why if you get a question like, should India stop using or should India stop developing hard power? So don't give a very yes or no kind of answer, because soft power itself has a lot of importance. Especially in the today's world, when we are talking about good governance, world over we are talking about good governance, world over we are talking about democratization of institutions, We are saying that UN should be democratized, there should be wider representation of the people. Then we are saying that instead of veto power, there should be more focus on consensus building. So consensus building is being talked about, good governance is being talked about. Okay? So these kind of things, what we need soft power. You cannot go for a good governance with hard power. So if in the question you get, then you can always write the limitations of, these are the limitations of the soft power, and in the conclusion, in your answers you write one or two line of conclusion also. So in the conclusion you can always write, like, in the changing global socio-economic political scenario where decisions are taken on consensus making, where we are talking about good governance, we need to have a proper balance between hard and soft power. That is, we need to follow a smart power approach rather than focusing only on hard or only on soft. Theek hai? Otherwise also we dekh lo ab what happens. America, Russia, they are doing bombing in so many places, but ultimately bombing does not lead to anywhere. They have to sit across the table and discuss the things. So that is what, without hard power, soft power does not have a value. So many times first you have to use the hard power and then come to the soft power. So that is why we need to have a balance between two. Theek hai? One topic is also completed, soft power. Now, see, you have to develop interest in international relations and you have to make it very interesting. Otherwise, so many things are happening every day, it becomes very difficult what all you will mug up. Kya kya ratoge? Kitna ratoge? Hai na? So make it interesting. Even history ko bhi try to make it interesting, because economic strength of a country. Yes, of course, because, but it's not totally economic strength. Of course, it's a major component, but at the same time, thoda bahut karta hai, but without, if you are not that strong an economic power, but still you can have soft power. Say, for example, Bhutan. Bhutan's approach of your GNP, gross national happiness. That is, Bhutan does not have that economic or military strength, but this thing every country across the globe appreciates. So it's not always the same thing. Okay? Bhutan is the only country which does not follow the concept of GDP, but it follows the concept of GNP, that is your gross national happiness. And the parameters they use are very, whether it's very interesting, the parameters also include measures like parameters, like if you are admitted in the hospital, how many people have come to see you there. Okay, that is also, it also determines your happiness, the parameter on which they calculate. Hota hai, hasne ki baat nahi, pad jao bimar, char phone nahi aaye to lagta hai yaar koi puch nahi raha. Theek hai? So that also determines how rich you might be. You might be in the five star hospital. Theek hai? Now hospitals are five star, but no one is coming to ask you, ab bimar ho, how will you feel? So that is also one of the components. Now, okay, so we have understood what is your foreign policy, what are the main determinants of a foreign policy. Now, whenever we make a foreign policy, there should be certain objectives, and whatever I am giving you, it is all from your MEA content. Okay? Even if you want to see anything, you can go to MEA website, go to IDSA website, don't go to any website, bahut sare, because nowadays everyone is like writing anything or everything about all the issues. So go to the some authentic websites. First and foremost is your MEA websites, then go to the websites of different embassies and all of different countries. Those are the authentic government things. Okay? Now, what are the goals of India's foreign policy? See, you might think these questions would not be asked, but I will tell you how to use the lines given here. When you should be knowing that each and every line that is given there, okay, how to use it. Question might not come in this format, ki what are the goals, but the goals that we are talking about, that those lines you can use in your answers. When we are talking about development of soft power, or should India invest or not, then what is our goal? If you are being asked why a country like India is giving 5 billion LOC to a developing country, why we are giving, so there might be certain goals. Why are we investing in Africa? Why are we giving loans to African countries when we ourselves have Odisha and Bihar with us? Okay? Nee, problems are there. So there are certain goals. It's question might not be asked in this format, but you should be knowing. See, in UPSC, the only thing is everyone knows everything. The art of writing, the art of manipulating your answers, that gives you point. How you are presenting your answers. That is, someone will get 3, someone will get 4, and someone will get 5.5 or 6. ठीक है, maximum. 7, 10 तो नहीं आता है. 20 में 10 means, see how much marks you will get then. Okay, so what are the goals of India's foreign policy? Okay, yes, first and the foremost goal you can write is maintenance and promotion of international peace and security. Maintenance and promotion of international peace and security. That is why we believe in the institution of United Nations. ठीक है? Then, comprehensive disarmament. Comprehensive disarmament. Disarmament. What do you mean by this? Disarmament. Disarmament means there should be no proliferation of any kinds of weapons, arms, ammunitions. We try to promote that through our foreign policy. Then, third is your elimination of hunger, poverty, illiteracy. Elimination of hunger, poverty, illiteracy, etc. That is why we are giving LOCs to other countries. Okay? Why we are giving? Because one of our goals is, because if the whole region is in stability, then of course there will be development. It's not only if India is developed, then the whole thing will happen. Unless and until your neighborhood, immediate and your extended neighborhoods peaceful, you cannot develop. Okay? Supposedly you want to go for trade with Africa. Okay? And Africa, there is no proper, there is a lot of instability. So if that region is not stable, how can you develop trade with Africa? So to promote stability there, we also try from our end. So that is one of our goals. Then, maintenance of friendly relationship with all. Friendly relationship with all. Okay. Promotion of universal brotherhood. Peaceful coexistence. That is why we don't go for peaceful coexistence. We don't go for attacking countries. We believe in the policy of no first use. Okay? You can relate these things. If you are, because right now no first use is too much in news. There is always every 2-3 months you get a question mark on whether we should change our policy. So when you are writing for positive things, why we should go for it, you can use these kind of things because our foreign policy goal believes in this. Okay? Then peaceful settlement of international disputes. peaceful settlement of international disputes. That is why we have accepted the judgments of Permanent Court of Arbitration, where LBA, then maritime dispute with, not LBA, LBA was not never gone to PCA. It was your maritime boundary settlement with Bangladesh. LBA was a joint thing. We will do it. Okay? That was a joint thing. It never went to PCA. So what we are doing is we are okay. So maritime boundary, we accepted it. Or abhi jab South China Sea thing has happened, so India said like morally our stature has increased because we have accepted, but it has not accepted. So that is what is the main thing. There is an online query. Video was hanged for 2 minutes, so online students skipped soft power, smart power topics. Could you repeat, please? We will repeat in the end. ठीक है, वी विल रिपीट इट इन द एंड, बिकॉज राइट नाउ आप लोग को शुड वी रिपीट इट नाउ, लास्ट में विल डू इट, रिमाइंड मी आई विल डू इट. ठीक है नाउ, ठीक है, दीज आर द गोल्स एंड दीज गोल्स आर मेड ऑन सर्टेन पिलर्स दैट वी हैव डिटरमाइंड. नाउ व्हाट आर द प्रिंसिपल्स दैट वी फॉलो to achieve these goals? What are the principles that we follow? What are the principles that we follow? Panchsheel is there. NAM is there, non-aligned. What else? Act East is a policy. Gujral doctrine. Do we? Have we ever come across this thing? ठीक है, one by one we will do these things also. Then, no first use we will do when we will do nuclear thing. ठीक है, one day we'll do whole nuclear diplomacy. ठीक है, India का. But this is also one principle that we follow. No first use. What else? Anti-apartheid, colonialism, etc. Do we follow the policy of apartheid? No. Why? This is what is the newspapers are saying and we are reading, and this, yes, dekho, this is the topic that everyone is saying we are not following this policy or that thing or that. ठीक है, if always remember, I always, मतलब जितना आप नहीं होते उससे ज़्यादा I am focused. ठीक है, कि we are to get marks in the exam. So think like a future bureaucrat. You are not writing this exam to become a politician. You are writing this exam to become a bureaucrat. If you ask any government official, will he or she say that we are not following this policy? Has any of the government website said that we are not following this policy? No. But your newspapers, your TV channels for TRPs, Arnab Goswami kind of debates, they will say whatever they want. ठीक है, सो दैट इज वॉट आई एम सेइंग. राइट नाउ वी हैव इंफॉर्मेशन ओवरफ्लो एंड डोंट गेट, मतलब इमोशनल नहीं होना है उसके साथ हमें. इवन इफ यू आर राइटिंग समथिंग फॉर पाकिस्तान, नेवर शो दैट यू हैव अ रेडिकलिस्ट अप्रोच टुवर्ड्स पाकिस्तान. सी वॉट योर करंट, हु इज योर करंट MEA स्पोक्स पर्सन? जो विकास स्वरूप हैज गॉन टू कैनेडा, नाउ बागले इज देयर, है ना, समवन इज, ठीक है, ये सब पढ़ो, कौन है क्या है, एक दिन में नहीं होगा, जब इंटरव्यू आएगा पता ही नहीं चलेगा हम क्या क्या प्रिपेयर कर रहे हैं उस टाइम पे. सो इफ यू सी देम, देयर हैव बीन स्कर्मिशेस, देयर हैव बीन ब्रीचेस ऑफ LOC, वट एवर, देयर हैज बीन पॉलिटिशियंस हियर हैव गिवन स्लोगन्स लाइक खून और पानी एक साथ नहीं बह सकता, ब्लड एंड वाटर कैनॉट फ्लो टुगेदर, वेन वी वर देयर फॉर इंडस वाटर कैलिब्रेशन. बट the way our foreign spokesman speaks, he never speaks like these terms. So you have to think like that. Some incidences does not mean one secular, one secluded kind of a incidence does not mean that the whole nation is not following this policy. ठीक है, दे डू इट फॉर देयर वोट बैंक पॉलिटिक्स, बट वी आर हियर टू बिकम ब्यूरोक्रैट. सो दीज थिंग्स डोंट थिंक ओनली इन योर इंटरव्यूज योर पर्सनैलिटी इज रिफ्लेक्टेड, इन योर आंसर्स योर पर्सनैलिटी इज रिफ्लेक्टेड. So we follow, in principle we follow this. One or two incidents does not mean that we don't follow. ठीक है, similarly attacks against Indians in USA, that does not mean that USA is following the apartheid policy. Okay, now one by one, what is Panchsheel, when was it signed? 1954, prelims. If you know it, good. Otherwise, if you want, you can write in your notes and write PT there, so that when you revise it, आपके लिए convenient होगा. 1954, India and China. ठीक है, between India and China, Panchsheel was followed. Sorry, Panchsheel was signed. What does it mean? Panch means five. So what are the five principles of Panchsheel? What are the five principles? Because see, right now Panchsheel is one principle which was signed between India and China, but India follows holistically Panchsheel with all the countries. It's not, theek hai, sign kiya tha, banaya tha, we have made it with China, but this theory of Panchsheel we follow with all the countries that we deal with. ठीक है, सो व्हाट आर द फाइव प्रिंसिपल्स? फाइव प्रिंसिपल्स आर म्यूचुअल रिस्पेक्ट फॉर ईच अदर्स टेरिटोरियल इंटीग्रिटी एंड सोवेनिटी. डोंट इंडिया फॉलो दिस विद अदर कंट्रीज? वी गिव रिस्पेक्ट टू देयर सोवेनिटी. ठीक है, दैट इज व्हाई ऑफ लेट MEA ऑलवेज टॉक्स अबाउट दिस. Ministry of External Affairs always talks about it, that we follow Panchsheel with all the nations. It's theek hai, primarily it was signed between India and China. So mutual respect for each other's territorial integrity and sovereignty. Second is your mutual non-aggression. Theek hai, then mutual non-interference in each other's internal affairs. In each other's internal affairs. Equality and mutual benefit. Equality and mutual benefit. Last is your peaceful coexistence. Peaceful coexistence. ठीक है, Panchsheel, it has relevance all the times for India. ठीक है, in our foreign policy, it will never lose its relevance. Second comes your NAM, non-aligned movement. इसको last में करेंगे because थोड़ा. What is Gujral doctrine? When was it? 1996. Why it is always in news? There is one term associated with it which we always read in the newspapers. Say for example, abhi BRICS summit has happened in India. Where? Goa. September we had BRICS summit. There also India has given support to Myanmar, and in the all the newspapers the term was used was asymmetrical support. Asymmetrical support. You might have read this kind of word. India always goes for asymmetrical support in the neighborhood. So what is this asymmetrical support? This is your Gujral doctrine. Now what is symmetrical maths? Symmetry is equal. Okay? Both sides equal, that is your symmetry. And asymmetry means unequal. Okay? Dono barabar nahi hai. It's not symmetry, it's unequal. So unequal is your means you are not reciprocating the way the other is doing. That is your asymmetrical support. Okay? Now see, Gujral doctrine, first just listen and then write. Gujral doctrine, you might get a question like, what is Gujral doctrine? Okay? Do you critically analyze its relevance in the present Indian foreign policy? Critically analyze the significance of Gujral doctrine in our foreign policy, or critically analyze the significance of Gujral doctrine in the present times. This might be the question. So first is, what is Gujral doctrine? See, in 1996, when Mr. I.K. Gujral, who was he? That time he was foreign minister. Okay? During that time, to improve the relationship with the neighborhood, in the neighborhood, he has given this doctrine. What is the essence of this doctrine? The essence of this doctrine is that India in the neighborhood, if you see in the South Asia, India is the largest economy, largest in size and resource. Okay? And the neighboring countries, you see countries like Nepal is there, Bhutan is there, even with Pakistan also we have extended Gujral doctrine. Then there are the countries are not at par with us. So if we want to develop, we cannot do it alone. What can we do is like, okay, within India we can develop. But right now the world is a globalized village. We need connectivity. Okay? We need connectivity. And the connectivity will happen through where? India udke to nahi America jayega har cheez ke liye. You need to go through the neighborhood only. Roads, ports, everything needs to be built across the neighborhood. And then second thing is, we have porous borders. India has porous borders. If there is some kind of problem in Nepal, if there is problem in Bangladesh, naturally people will, the problem will have a cascading effect. They will inflow into India. So it's not that, since we are the one who is having the resource, we have the capacity, so it should be our duty that we should also help these smaller countries to develop, so that overall there is peace and stability in the region. And if there is no peace and stability, then no economic development will happen. Okay, economic development nahi ho payegi, because right now the way world is moving around, it is a globalized village. So it is always advisable that instead of only cribbing about the instability in the neighborhood, try to help them when you have the resources, and that is ultimately for your benefit only. Because if there is stability in the region, then only the FDI will come into this region. FDI will never come in a disturbed region. You can develop connectivity. You can have relationship with other countries, okay, passing through these countries. So that is why it was said that it is the principle of non-reciprocity. Means India will help the countries, and India will not, I will dictate you, India will not accept anything in return. Okay? So that is your Gujral doctrine. So do you think it still has relevance? Yes, it has relevance. We need the stability. Hamare charot, if you get a question like, do you think Gujral doctrine still has relevance? If you see, because of the underdevelopment, radicalization is spreading across India. You take Afghanistan, you take Pakistan, you take Myanmar, Buddhist radicalism is growing there. You take Sri Lanka, Sinhalese, and you have Tamils, there also Buddhist nationalism is growing. So every kind of radicalization, all those things are happening in which areas? Where there is no development. Now we are talking about connectivity, we are talking about Sitwe project. From where will it happen? It will pass through your Myanmar. Theek hai? If we are talking about BBIN corridor, if we are talking about Tapi, theek hai? It will, Afghanistan and Pakistan is also there. So yes, this doctrine has a relevance today. ठीक है, बिकॉज वी एंड मोर ओवर इंडिया वॉन्ट्स टू बिकम अ सुपर पावर. हम चाह रहे हैं ना यूएनएससी पोजिशन, सुपर पावर लीडर, ग्लोबल लीडर. सो इफ वी आर नॉट एबल टू डेवलप आवर ओन बैकयार्ड, हाउ कैन वी क्लेम टू बी अ सुपर पावर और अ ग्लोबल लीडर? सो येस, दिस डॉक्ट्रिन हैज लॉट ऑफ इम्पॉर्टेंस इन टूडेज सिनारियो. नाउ बट यूपीएससी इज वेरी स्मार्ट, इट आस्क्स यू क्रिटिकली एनालाइज. तो you have to make points negative also, theek hai? Because wahan pe if they are asking you critically analyze something and you are writing very good answer for positive and you are not writing the other part of the answer, and if that positive part of the answer is carrying say for example 5 marks, so you will get out of 5 1.5, because each and every aspect of the question is allocated different marks. So you have to touch all the aspects of the question. So you should be knowing the negatives of this also. So what are the negatives of Gujral doctrine? Gujral doctrine's negative is sometimes it is misused. So many times it is being misused. Say for example, because of Gujral doctrine, we have given certain liberal visas and we have taken away our raw desk from Pakistan. ठीक है, under this की we trust you, हमने अपना raw IB desk हटा दिया. And we have seen that there had been increase in infiltration, so it has been misused by our neighbors. Then what has happened? Many times they use it as a bargaining chip. What happens is, like, say for example, current scenario, India is dealing with Nepal, even China is also luring Nepal. So under this doctrine they are saying you give us this because China is giving this. So at times it is being misused. One example is your Pakistan, another is your China card they play. Theek hai? Apart from that Gujral doctrine, another thing is many times they take it as in your interference. ठीक है, why you are giving us free loans? It means you want to have some kind of upper hand in our internal politics. So Gujral doctrine is what? Your line of credit you are giving. So what is the limitation of soft power applies here also. ठीक है, so you are saying that you are interfering, big brother attitude. ठीक है, आप बहुत दिखा रहे हो, बहुत पैसा दे रहे हो, you are interfering, that is also there. And then resource crunch, if we are giving too much, then questions are being raised in the parliament, why are you giving so much? We also have a proper your KBK districts in Orissa, we also have your Bimaru states in India. Theek hai, so why are you giving? So then that internal and external political balance becomes a problem to maintain. So that these are the limitations of your Gujral doctrine. ठीक है, so please always try to see whatever is your personal opinion about any issue. No first use, नहीं होना चाहिए, होना चाहिए, that is your personal issue. ठीक है, but the question will ask you critically analyze. So you should be having 5 points for that and 5 points for that, both the sides. And then your final conclusion should be a balanced approach. It should not be personally, you might think anyways ki bhaiya no first use nahi chahiye hame, we don't want no first use, but in the exam if they are saying, you have to write why we want it, why should we have it. Theek hai, so personal opinions anti apartheid, yes we follow this. And if there is some key, if you get a question like in the current, I don't know isme to nahi aayega, but sociology mein some way you might get a question like, do you think the current unrest in India means that India does not follow the policy of apartheid or something or like that? ठीक है, the current unrest in the Indian society, do they in क्या unity in diversity, do you think the diversity is getting impacted because all this kind of question might be there. So you can always give the examples, critically analyze. Okay, in critically analysis or in the essays also you get this kind of topics. Do you think unity and diversity is getting impacted or whatever? So you can do is, You can always write some of the incidences have shown this, but still, India believes in the constitution and our constitution talks about these things. Some of the incidences have raised the issue or raised the question mark. You, that art of writing answers. Some of the like different instances have raised the question mark, but still our constitution, our foreign policy talks about this. That way you have to handle the things. So Gujral doctrine, write few points. It was given in 1996. What is the essence of this doctrine? Essence, being the largest country in South Asia, being the largest country in South Asia, India decided on, whose phone? India decided on extension of unilateral concessions to neighbors in the subcontinent, unilateral concessions to neighbors in the subcontinent in pursuance of this policy. ठीक है, गुजराल डॉक्ट्रिन, यू कैन राइट मैथमेटिकल फॉर्मूला, गुजराल डॉक्ट्रिन इज इक्वल टू पंचशील प्लस प्रिंसिपल ऑफ नॉन रेसिप्रोसिटी प्लस प्रिंसिपल ऑफ नॉन रेसिप्रोसिटी non-reciprocity, you can write unilateral concession, asymmetrical support, because these are the terms for non-reciprocity that you read in the newspapers. Unilateral concessions, ठीक है, और asymmetrical support, etc. ठीक है, plus no South Asian country, right? No South Asian country should allow its territory to be used against the interest of another country of the region. ठीक है, examples 1996 we have Ganga water treaty with Bangladesh. 1996 Ganga water treaty, PT fact, Sheikh Hasina was here, hai na, that was another thing, Farakka barrage and all, we will discuss when we will do Bangladesh, theek hai? Then 1997 unilateral concessions to Pakistan tourists, especially elder citizens, etc. ठीक है, elder citizens, we gave some unilateral things. ठीक है, now what are the positives of this? You can write few points. It recognizes the importance of friendly coordination with neighborhood. It recognizes the importance of friendly coordination with neighborhood. Emphasizes on the principle of equity rather than equality. Emphasizes on the principle of equity rather than equality for the sustainable development of the region. ठीक है, increases confidence building. Etc. Now, equity and equality. What is the difference between equity and equality? Equity and equality, there are two terms. Are we aware of the difference? How many of we are not aware of what is the difference between equity and equality? Okay. Say, for example, there is a group of three people here. And there is a group of five people here. Okay? As per the principle of equality, both the group, five people and three people, both the groups are hungry. As per the principle of equality, both the groups should, like equality says, equal chapatis to both the groups. The one group is getting three, the other group is also getting three. But if you see, the problem is more vigorous here. Here you have five. So as per the principle of equality, both the groups should be given the same. But as per the principle of equity, first we need to understand that here five people are hungry. So it's about hunger. It's not always about equity, equality. So they will be given five chapatis. So that is your equity. And because for sustainable development, what is this concept of sustainable development? What is this? What do you understand when we say sustainable development? See, without compromising the resources, that is your one component of your development. That is your ecological component. Okay? Sustainable development means a development which has sustainability in terms of your social development, in terms of your economic development, as well as your environmental development. Okay? It's not only about environment. Development can be sustainable only when everyone is safe or within India. India can have a sustainable development when all the sections of the society are developed. Then only we can have a long-term development. Otherwise, what is happening right now? 1% of the population is controlling your 58% of the resources. Latest Oxfam report. Okay? Latest one. It says 1% of the population in India is holding 58% of your resources. So can you think how many people are below your poverty line in India? What percentage of people? Prelims, economic survey, one line they give you. Which of the following is correct? 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so these small facts, how many people are below poverty line, BPL families, how many of them are there? There might be a question like universal basic income, one chapter in your economic survey. Okay, UBI is there, so UBI will help to uplift this much population from below poverty line. So how much population? You should be knowing that. Okay, so that these are small facts. Okay. So, equality and equity difference samajh mein aaya. And again, I would suggest you, when you read the definition of poverty, you read the definition of drought, you read the definition of hunger, you read the definition of sustainable development, please don't refer to your Wikipedia, refer to your World Bank website, refer to your IMF website, refer to what UN defines drought as, because abhi 4 countries ko drought has been declared in 4 countries. Are we aware of that? Yes. Worst ever humanitarian crisis since UN has formed. So that is the statement given by your UN. So what is the definition of drought? Don't go by Wikipedia. Go by these sources. This will help you even in your essays also, because sustainable development is not only your environment. See how World Bank defines sustainable development. ठीक है, ये definitions वहां से देखा करो. Wikipedia should be your last source. Then negatives about this is what is there in your soft power. You can add that, no point of repeating it, है ना? Gujral doctrine negatives could be, you can add the negatives of your soft power. Now Panchsheel is there, Nam, Gujral, anti-apartheid, okay. Now what, let us talk about Nam. What is this? Nam is your non-aligned movement. When was it formed? When did India adopt Nam? See, this is a PT cum mains class, na? Foundation batch is there, no? Or is it only mains? PT cum mains. So we will, jahan jahan pe hoga, we will discuss small small facts also, so that holistic coverage is there. When was Nam as an institution, when was it formed, or when did India adopt Nam? 1950 1960 1951 1961 1961. Yahan tick marna hai, 61. Bandung Conference, is associated with which of the following? Nam. ठीक है, Bandung Conference. When was it? 1955. It is associated with Nam, Bandung Conference. Many times they give you the name of the conference and they ask you with which it is associated. Bandung Conference is associated with Nam. What has happened? Where is Bandung? It's a place, huh? Many of us don't know that it's a place also. So Bandung is a place. Where is it? Indonesia. So in 1955, there are 5 names. I'll give you the names. The leaders, they came together and they, in principle, they decided that we will not get aligned either to USA or to the USSR. We will remain non-aligned. So in principle, they decided here, and formal the organization was formed in 1961. That is your NAM. ठीक है, non-aligned movement. Who are the 5 who are called the 5 pillars of NAM or the fathers of NAM? India's Jawaharlal Nehru, then Indonesia, Sukarno, ठीक है, लिखते जाओ, those who know very good, those who don't know please write. India, Jawaharlal Nehru, Indonesia, Sukarno, Yugoslavia, Joseph Broz Tito, Joseph Broz, B-R-O-Z, Yugoslavia is your Joseph Broz Tito, B-R-O-Z, Joseph Broz, T-I-T-O, Tito, Joseph Broz Tito, Yugoslavia is there, then Egypt, Kon, Abdul Nasir, Gamal Abdul Nasir, his name was Gamal, G-A-M-A-L, Gamal Abdul Nasir, N-A-S-I-R, Gamal Abdul Nasir. Then 5th one, huh? Cuba, that is Cuba, Fidel Castro. Then Ghana, Kwame Nkrumah, K W A M E, K W A M E, Kwame Nkrumah. ठीक है, सो नैम वॉज फॉर्म्ड इन 1961. वॉट इज द स्टोरी बिहाइंड अ नैम नॉन अलाइंड? सी, कोल्ड वॉर वॉज गोइंग ऑन, देर वर टू सुपर पावर्स, यूएसए एंड यूएसएसआर. ठीक है, सो these countries who formed, who came together under the umbrella of NAM, all of them were newly independent countries. ठीक है, all of them were newly independent countries, so they did not want to go either with USA or with USSR because they did not want to be aligned. अभी अभी तो आजाद हुए उनसे, and again now you are going aligning to them. That is one thing. Emotional aspects were also there. The countries which has colonized, say for example India, 200 years, why should we get aligned with the Western power again? ठीक है, so the newly aligned countries, they had their own problems and they were the superpowers. So they have their own money, wealth, and the newly independent countries, they were not having those resources, and so, and at the same time they did not want to piggyback along with these countries because then they have to follow it directly. No colonialism, but indirect they will be losing their sovereignty. So they wanted to enjoy the newly attained freedom. So they formed that NAM. Now, if you get a question like, and this has been too much in news, criticism of NAM, that many of our people have talked about, that NAM has no relevance, hai na? Especially when this was in the news, when we signed LEMOA. LEMOA, America ke saath kiya tha, logistic exchange memorandum of agreement, that we will do when we will be doing USA. That time it was in the news, and then last year NAM summit was there in Egypt and Venezuela, and who was not there? Our prime minister did not go, but our vice president go. And then at the same time S. J. Shankar has also given one statement which also talked about that NAM is losing relevance. So if you get a question, सी नाम में कैसे कैसे क्वेश्चन आ सकते हैं. फर्स्ट पीटी में क्वेश्चन आ सकते हैं, दैट वी हैव डन, कि व्हाट, व्हेन वाज इट फॉर्म्ड, विच कॉन्फ्रेंस इज एसोसिएटेड विद इट, हु आर द फाउंडिंग फादर्स ऑफ नाम, दैट कैन बी अ क्वेश्चन, एंड वेयर वाज द लास्ट समिट हेल्ड, दैट कैन बी अ क्वेश्चन इन पीटी. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन माइट बी रेज्ड इन मेन्स? मेन्स में क्वेश्चन माइट बी, व्हाट डू यू थिंक इन द करंट scenario, NAM as an organization has relevance? ठीक है, do you think NAM has a relevance? Number one, that can be a question. Or there might be a question like, critically analyze the relevance of NAM in our, relevance of NAM as a tool of India's foreign policy, because NAM is also there, we follow the principle of NAM, non-alignment. ठीक है, सो डू यू थिंक नैम हैज अ रेलिवेंस इन इंडियाज फॉरेन पॉलिसी इन द करेंट सिनारियो? डू यू थिंक इट इज देयर? भैया थोड़ा गर्म पानी देना. सो डू यू थिंक दैट नैम हैज अ रेलिवेंस इन करेंट फॉरेन पॉलिसी? सेकेंड थिंग इज नैम एज अ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. सो हाउ विल यू एनालाइज? कैसे पता चलेगा इसका रेलिवेंस है या नहीं है? वॉट डू वी नीड टू नो? वी नीड टू नो लिटिल बिट ऑफ हिस्ट्री. What were the objectives of NAM when it was formed? Then only we can understand that whether it has relevance today or not, isn't it? That is why I am saying whenever we read IR, little bit of history is very much required. Okay, NAM ka as an organization, do we have relevance? So what was the objective when NAM was formed? Then only we can understand, no, ki whether it has relevance today or not. The objective was something, today it is applicable or not. So see, why a question mark is being raised on NAM is, बिकॉज नैम वॉज फॉर्म ड्यूरिंग योर कोल्ड वॉर पीरियड. ठीक है, वाई अ क्वेश्चन मार्क ऑन नैम? नैम वॉज फॉर्म ड्यूरिंग योर कोल्ड वॉर पीरियड वेन वी हैड USA and USSR. ठीक है, राइट नाउ why we are saying NAM has no relevance as an organization, because that time it was your bipolar world. But after 1990s breakdown of USSR, ठीक है, NAM was in reaction to your USA and USSR bipolar. And now this is no more in existence. So what is the relevance of NAM? ठीक है, ये समझ में आया? That is why it is said that critically analyze. So why NAM has no relevance? First is your, why no relevance? Because it was formed during your Cold War period. कोल्ड वॉर सिचुएशन डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट. ठीक है, अब ये सीरिया वीरिया बीच में जबरदस्ती नहीं घुसाना है कि सीरिया में भी तो कोल्ड वॉर चल रहा है. ठीक है, दैट इज समथिंग विच वी विल नॉट डिस्कस हियर. दैट इज समथिंग विच योर न्यूज़ पेपर्स एंड ऑल आर सेइंग. नो वेयर UN इज सेइंग कोल्ड वॉर इज गोइंग ऑन. वी विल गो एज अ फ्यूचर ब्यूरोक्रैट ओनली. ठीक है, सो इट हैज़ नो रेलिवेंस. नंबर टू, वन पॉइंट इज दिस. नंबर टू, सेकेंड पॉइंट इज, इफ यू सी in today's world, now countries are interdependent in on all the aspects, whether it is economy, whether it is polity, whether it is geography. Theek hai, countries are having relationship with all the countries, they need each other. Theek hai, to aaj ke time pe we have global problems which need global solutions. Say for example, we have international terrorism. Had it been possible, then USA could have alone tackled terrorism. But why USA is asking for all the countries to join it? Because now the global problems, the new problems that has emerged, Cold War era problems were different. But today the problems are different. New global challenges, like terrorism, like climate change, etc., need integrated solution, isn't it? Can one country alone deal with climate change? No. We cannot say ki okay, we belong to this block, we will not participate in climate change. We belong to this part, we will not go for global problem solution. So right now there is, that is why question mark is being raised, because global new scenario has come up. It's no longer the Cold War period. Now we have global challenges which need a integrated solution. We cannot remain in silos. Had it been the case, right now you might say ki okay, USA or China ke beech mein bhi to Cold War chal raha hai. But if you see China and USA, how much is the bilateral trade between these two countries? Somewhere around 750 billion US dollar. Theek hai? So can they fight with each other? No. Globally they are saying whatever they are doing. OBOR, USA is not a part. TPP, China was not the part. But China, the reality is China is the biggest trading partner of USA. And they cannot fight. ठीक है, सो दैट काइंड ऑफ सिचुएशन राइट नाउ इज देयर विच वॉज नॉट ड्यूरिंग योर कोल्ड वॉर टाइम्स. कोल्ड वॉर टाइम्स में नो वन वॉज टू मच डिपेंडेंट. सो दैट इज वाई इट इज सेड दैट नैम हैज नो रेलिवेंस. इतना समझ में आया? क्रिटिकली एनालाइज का वन पार्ट इज कवर्ड, दैट वाई इट हैज नो रेलिवेंस. नाउ वाई इट हैज रेलिवेंस? तो वो तो हम लिखेंगे ना कि रेलिवेंस है, उसमें ये सब डालेंगे ना. बट दिस ग्रुप हैज अ लिमिटेड पार्टिसिपेशन. what you are saying, I am understanding, but the group has a limited participation. हाँ ठीक है, यूएन में 194 कंट्रीज हैं, ठीक है, विच इज द लेटेस्ट वन, साउथ सूडान. चलो नाउ व्हाट, you can give that example also, Yugoslavia wala you are saying, no, ki it could not help bifurcate it, hai na, Herzegovina and wo, theek hai, you can give that example also. Now the question is, see, another thing is, again I would say what you are saying is okay, but points critically analyze, negative, positive, कुछ points होंगे, बहुत emotional. IR is something where you, we get all emotionals, ठीक है, उनको एक side रख के we will first write few points, ठीक है, and then what you are saying is we can use it, we will be discussing the relevance of NAM as a group is still there, so there you can integrate what you are saying, ठीक है. Now the question is, do we see any kind of relevance of NAM as a group? For that we need to understand what was the objective of NAM. What was the objective of NAM when it was formed? Have we ever read about it? Padha hai? See, that was one thing, ki not aligned. Means you are saying we are not aligning, means you are giving preference to your independence, your sovereignty. That does not, that means this only, no, you are not aligning because you want your own sovereignty, you want your own independence. And see the stature. अब ये मत कहना कि जो साथ में उनका independence चला गया तो वो countries कौन थी, और NAM में which are the countries, what kind of countries are in NAM? That is what we have discussed, ki earlier those were the superpowers and these were the newly formed countries which were very weak economically, socially, education wise, from all aspects. NAM that time, is some dominant power there in the NAM? No. Theek hai, to thoda holistically socho, then argue about that. So see, non-aligning means you are going for self-determination. You will be determining yourself. You will not be you will not get determined by others. So write few objectives, main objectives. If you see the NAM charter, it is very long, but the points which are of relevance, so I am giving you those points only, few important points. Number one, support of self-determination. National independence, self-determination, comma, national independence. Sovereignty and territorial integrity. Opposition to apartheid. Apartheid, then democratization of international relations. What do you understand by democratization? Means voices of these countries should also be heard, should be given importance. Democratization of international relations, strengthening of United Nations. Then restructuring of international economic systems. ठीक है, now you see all these things, do you think these things have relevance today? Do these things have relevance? Hey? The objectives which were there are still very much valid. All the countries would want to have their own sovereignty. They are going, all the countries are demanding for your democratization. All the countries are demanding for your more democratic United Nations. So NAM as a group still has your relevance. See, now what has changed? Earlier, these were called the third world countries because there were two worlds. One was USA and the second was your USSR. These were called the third world countries. And I will dictate you one point about this also. Earlier, they were called third world countries. But now, the nomenclature has changed. Now, they are called your South-South cooperation or your developing countries or the least developed countries. Problems are the same. उस टाइम भी वो गरीब थे, आज भी ये गरीब है, ठीक है? उस टाइम भी वहाँ पे पॉवर्टी वाज देयर, नाउ आल्सो योर लीस्ट डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज, योर साउथ साउथ कोऑपरेशन, साउथ साउथ कोऑपरेशन, हाउ मेनी ऑफ अस अंडरस्टैंड द टर्म? साउथ साउथ कोऑपरेशन इज द कोऑपरेशन ऑफ द developing and least developing countries in the southern part of your globe. Say for example your Asia falls in the southern part. इक्वेटर के साउथ में है. यू सी लैटिन अमेरिकन कंट्रीज साउथ में है. यू सी अफ्रीकन कंट्रीज, मेनली आपकी मेजॉरिटी इज इन साउथ. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड योर साउथ साउथ कोऑपरेशन. सो इफ यू सी स्टिल टुडे द प्रॉब्लम्स रिमेन द सेम. अर्लियर दीज कंट्रीज, योर यूएसए एंड यूएसएसआर वर एक्सप्लॉइटिंग दीज कंट्रीज. And now in the globalized new global era, we talk about neoliberalism, we talk about your industrialization, and in the name of all these things, the developed countries are exploiting your developing countries. They are extracting their raw material, they are dumping their goods there. So the problem remains the same. So if, and now this group has realigned itself to your fulfillment of your Millennium Development Goal, Sustainable Development Goal, and within this developing countries, we have a group called G77. Pata hai G77? G20 is there, G15 is there, prelims is coming. G77 is the group of developing countries. G77, India is a leader of this group. G77, मतलब we are a very dominant voice. So just G77 group जो है, it acts for the bargaining, it acts to bargain for benefit of your developing countries, and India is a major voice in this. So right now the problems remain the same. The only thing is the terminologies have changed. So this group, yes, it has a relevance. And moreover, there are certain structural changes that needs to be taken care of to adjust with the new scenario. So this group still has a relevance. ठीक है? क्यों नहीं है? वो भी we have done, and क्यों है? We have done. And you have to do both the things. If the question comes critically analyzed, you cannot say कि ऐसा है, ऐसा है, इसको हम हटा देंगे. तो ऐसा नहीं है. वहाँ to get a 6 marks or 7 marks, you have to write. So you should be having points. So write the points. Relevance as a group. Okay, relevance as a group. Number one. Earlier, NAM looked after the interest of developing countries, sorry, third world countries, looked after the interests of third world countries, okay? And now the nomenclature has changed to developing countries, least developing countries, LDCs, or South-South cooperation, etc. But the problem remains the same. ठीक है, ड्यू टू ग्लोबल नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, ड्यू टू ग्लोबलाइजेशन एंड नियो लिबरल पॉलिसीज, नियो लिबरल पॉलिसीज, दीज कंट्रीज आर स्टिल एक्सप्लॉयटेड बाय द डेवलप्ड नेशंस. ठीक है, थर्ड पॉइंट, नाम हैज रेज्ड वॉइस फॉर यूएन रिफॉर्म्स. ठीक है, हैज रेज्ड वॉइस फॉर यूएन रिफॉर्म्स कॉमा राइट्स ऑफ डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज इन डब्ल्यूटीओ. WTO all the time developing and developed countries are fighting. So rights of developing countries under WTO etc. UN reforms की भी बात कर रहे, WTO में भी we are fighting. So NAM as a group has a relevance. The only thing is we need to realign to the present realities. You like यहीं पे G77 भी लिख लो फॉर योर प्रिलिम्स. G77 अ ग्रुप ऑफ डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज. तो नैम इज बेसिकली अ ग्रुप ऑफ डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज. सो व्हेन यू हैव अ ग्रुप ऑफ डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज यू आर एट अ बेटर पोजिशन टू बार्गेन एट WTO, एट UN, है ना, यू हैव अ बेटर पोजिशन टू बार्गेन. सो दिस हैज अ रेलिवेंस. ठीक है, सो नैम एज अ ग्रुप you can write positive and negative. Now come to NAM as a tool in our foreign policy, because we follow the principle of non-alignment, hai na, foreign policy's principle is non-alignment. Do you think it has relevance? First of why question mark? Question mark क्यों है? अच्छा, have you ever noticed that many times UPSC gives you a question, some statement given by some personality, they will remove the name and they will give you the statement and they will ask you to एक्सप्लेन दैट. ऐसा भी होता है, हुआ है ऐसा, देखा है कभी? ठीक है, सो देर वॉज अ स्टेटमेंट बाय एस जयशंकर, हु इज ही, फॉरेन सेक्रेटरी. आई विल गिव यू द स्टेटमेंट एंड देन राइट द क्वेश्चन एंड देन वी विल डिस्कस वेदर इट हैज रेलिवेंस और नॉट. यू कैन राइट ब्लॉक्स एंड अलायंसेस. Blocks and alliances are less relevant today and the world is moving towards a loosely arranged order. ठीक है, फुल स्टॉप. इन लाइट ऑफ दिस स्टेटमेंट, critically analyze NAM, critically analyze the significance of NAM as a tool in our foreign policy. I give lot many questions, ठीक है आप लोग थक जाओगे लिख लिख के, but under these questions your topic will be covered, ठीक है. Another statement which P.V. Narasimha Rao has given, you can write, don't write the name, बस write the statement. The pursuit of a non-aligned policy is even more relevant to ever before NAM. The pursuit of non-aligned policy is even more relevant to ever before NAM. मतलब पहले जब NAM बना था उससे भी ज़्यादा आज के टाइम पे इट इज़ मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट. अगेन क्रिटिकली एनालाइज द रेलिवेंस इन द लाइट ऑफ दिस स्टेटमेंट, क्रिटिकली एनालाइज द रेलिवेंस ऑफ NAM. सो डू यू थिंक NAM हैज़ एनी रेलिवेंस? Why did we join NAM first? Why did we join NAM or why did we adopt NAM in our foreign policy? Yes, see the reasons why we joined NAM or why we adopted NAM. First thing was the same reason which all the other countries had. We wanted to enjoy our newly gained independence. We did not want to be aligned to anyone. That time when we adopted NAM, what was the current scenario? So many developmental works were going on, ठीक है, and diplomatically, politically, it is advisable not to depend only on one bloc, ठीक है. So we wanted to get the benefits. USSR से we were getting some benefits, USA से भी we were getting aids, food security, PL 480 we were getting your other support from your Russia. आपके जो स्टील प्लांट बने, बुकारो स्टील प्लांट बना, वो सब बना, कब बना? विद द हेल्प ऑफ रशिया 1970s. सो वी वर हैविंग मेनी डेवलपमेंटल प्लान्स दैट टाइम एंड डिप्लोमैटिकली पॉलिटिकली इट्स नॉट एडवाइजेबल टू डिपेंड ओनली ऑन वन ब्लॉक, ठीक है. सो वी वॉन्टेड टू रिमेन एज इट इज. We wanted to remain neutral so that best of both the worlds. Then there were certain ideological and your emotional reasons also for not joining NAM. What were the ideological reasons? Why are you looking for watch? Do we take a break here in the class? Lete? Okay, we'll finish it fast, okay? Break kya lenge? Ek baar khatam kar lete hain. Isn't it interesting? लग रहा है इंटरेस्ट आ रहा है, ठीक है. आई थिंक यूपीएससी 3 घंटे में ब्रेक नहीं देता लिखते हुए, है ना. डेवलप दैट प्रैक्टिस एंड दैट टू सी इफ यू आर राइटिंग एग्जाम्स इन दिल्ली, योर एग्जाम इज इन द मंथ ऑफ जून, हियर यू आर सिटिंग इन एसी, देयर यू माइट गेट अ सेंटर वेयर देयर इज नो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, नो फैन, विंडोज विल बी ओपन, लू आ रही होगी आपको गरम गरम और आपको कॉन्सेंट्रेट होके लिखना होगा. सो डेवलप दिस हैबिट, ठीक है. नहीं तो वहाँ पे एफिशिएंसी यहीं से कम होती है बिकॉज वी डोंट नो हाउ टू सिट फॉर 3 आवर्स, ठीक है. घड़ी देखते हैं कितना अब कब ब्रेक होगा. इट्स नॉट अ मूवी ना कि देर विल बी इंटरमिशन, गो एंड बाय द पॉपकॉर्न्स एंड कम एंड देन सी द रेस्ट ऑफ द मूवी. ओके, व्हाट आर द इमोशनल रीजंस एंड आइडियोलॉजिकल रीजंस? सो हियर कम्स योर फॉरेन पॉलिसी, ठीक है. फॉरेन पॉलिसी वी टॉक्ड अबाउट दैट इन प्रिंसिपल वी डोंट फॉलो अपार्थेड. We don't believe in colonization and all those things. So during that time, if you see, many of the countries were either the colonial ex-colonial powers or they were still practicing colonialism. कहाँ कहाँ कर रहे थे African nations में आपके they were doing. So that was your ideological reason. We did not want to get aligned to the group which is a ex-colonial power or your practicing your colonialism. ठीक है, उस time जो कर रहे थे. तो there are certain ideological reasons also. And emotional reason was कि the countries which have ruled over us, which have ruined us, why should we get aligned to them? So these kind of reasons also. ठीक है, one reason why we joined because newly independent we want to enjoy our freedom. Second thing was we were running many of the developmental projects for which we did not want to rely only on one country or sorry on only on one group. Then we had our own ideological reasons, we had our own emotional reasons. So that is why we did not join any of the groups. Now why this kind of a statement by Jai Shankar? Because right now if you see, we are aligning with everyone. We are aligning with China, we are aligning with Russia. Let us talk about the major powers. ठीक है, we are aligning with China, we are aligning with Russia, we are aligning with USA. ठीक है, no more USSR, so we will use the term Russia. So we are aligning with all of them, we are aligning with your GCC countries also, we are aligning with Palestine as well as Israel, we are aligning with Iran as well as GCC. So that is why it is saying that it is now the statement is saying that blocks and alliances are less relevant. It is not saying totally irrelevant. They are saying they are less relevant today and the world is moving towards a loosely arranged order, not a very strongly arranged like two blocks. We have loosely arranged orders and now we are aligning with everyone. ठीक है, that is why in Pax Indica Shashi Tharoor has said that the new name is multi alignment. है ना, the new name is you are aligning with everyone. So if you see the current scenario when we are saying we are aligning with everyone, that time your name becomes very important. Why? Because earlier it was called, during Cold War era, it was called your non-alignment. And आजकल हम कौन सी term use करते हैं? We talk the term about strategic autonomy. We always say, है ना, present day में नाम की जगह what kind of term we use strategic autonomy. What do you understand when you read this word in the newspaper? It says your autonomy in decision making. ठीक है, so don't you think you need your autonomy in decision making? Does India need this autonomy? India will always need this autonomy. When Lemoa was signed, there was a question mark that we are going into a alliance with USA. But if you see the terms and conditions of Lemoa, nowhere it is written that we will be guided by USA in our strategic autonomy. No. So right now when we are aligning with different countries, we need to have our own autonomy because there are so many chances of getting influenced. है ना, अब आपके पास इतना इन्फ्लुएंस है, कभी यूएसए है, कभी चाइना है, कभी ईरान है, कभी जीसीसी है. सो यू नीड टू प्रिजर्व योर स्ट्रैटेजिक ऑटोनॉमी. सो नैम विल नेवर लूज द इम्पॉर्टेंस. सो यू कैन राइट दिस पॉइंट. द कोर ऑफ नैम, this is with respect to your foreign policy, hai na? The core of NAM was the defense of means protection of autonomy of decision making, or the protection of autonomy of decision making in foreign affairs. Which will always remain so. Hai na? NAM will always have an importance because we can never compromise on our autonomy. We never want that we should be guided by other countries. We should always be guided by our own national interest. So that is one thing. Second thing, NAM emphasizes on the principles of multilateralism. Means we believe that we should not be aligned to one group, you know, or one country. We believe in multilateralism. That is why we have also formed one group. Example, one of the groups is your RIC. Have you come across this word? RIC. RIC, Russia, India, China. RIC. That is one group. Example, you can write to substantiate your points. RIC. Russia, India, China. This is a group which is against the hegemony of US. Okay, RIC. We are a member of RIC, Russia, India, China. This group promotes your multilateralism. Okay, and NAM also promotes this in our foreign policy. We promote multilateralism. Then equality, mutual non-aggression, equality, mutual non-aggression, peaceful coexistence, universal brotherhood, etc., which are the basic principles of our foreign policy, isn't it? Which are the basic principles of our foreign policy. See, one of the reasons why we did not join NAM is our foreign policy, when we were discussing the basic things, it talks about your universal brotherhood. It talks about your peaceful coexistence. So Nehru ji that time thought, if we go for any of the alliances, USA or USSR, these are the alliances which is dividing the world into two groups. But we believe, our foreign policy believes in universal brotherhood. So it was also contradictory. So it's better, don't join any group which will divide the world. Rather, form a group which will promote your universal brotherhood. So this is what I said in the beginning, that the very basic things that we are doing, that we have done, ki principles kya hai, goals kya hai, you should know how to use it. If you are getting a question, the whether critically analyze NAM or this, and if you are connecting your answer, your points with these things, so who will stop the examiner from giving you 0.5 or 1 marks extra? And 1 marks means a lot. Okay? If you are getting 0.5, 0.5, 0.5 in all your answers, 10 marks. Additional 10 marks mein list mein yahan se yahan hote hain. And 1 marks is something, at times 1 marks you are out of PT, 1 marks you are not in your mains, 1 marks chalo selection bhi ho jata hai, theek hai, you get selected, 1 marks kaash 1 marks hota IPS nahi IAS ban jate, theek hai, kaash 1 marks hota if you become IAS, kaash 1 marks hota I could have got my home card out, theek hai, kaash 1 marks extra hota, काश तो होम कार्डर में भी सबसे ऊपर मेरा नाम होता, ठीक है. सो दैट 1 मार्क्स इन यूपीएससी इज वेरी क्रिटिकल. सो ट्राई टू ग्रैब मार्क्स बाय आर्टिकुलेटिंग योर आंसर्स, एंड दिस विल नेवर हैपन इफ यू थिंक कि फर्स्ट वी विल रीड एवरीथिंग एंड देन वी विल राइट. वंस यू कंप्लीट एवरीथिंग बाय दैट टाइम योर पीटी इज देयर, यू क्लियर योर पीटी, एंड इफ यू गेट थ्रू लकीली देन 2 months or 2.5 months are there, then you have to write mains. So please keep on writing your answers also. Just sitting in the class, discussing, debating, we can do at length. ठीक है, 4 दिन तक we can discuss NAM होना चाहिए नहीं होना चाहिए. But the thing is, when it comes to 200 words, that too when you have to devote 5 to 7 minutes for per answer, and that too quality answer. So practice also simultaneously, otherwise बहुत मुश्किल है, ठीक है. Then now you understood this is NAM. Another thing, just for your reference, there was a policy document by the name NAM 2.0. Have you come across this kind of policy document? NAM 2.0? It came in 2012. Okay? Just listen about it and see how you can use this information. This information you can still use to substantiate that NAM has a relevance. Okay? Pehle isko samajh lo. I will give you lots of information, but you need to link the information. Okay? Because that information, when you get the answers, questions, you always say, yaar, kaise current se karna hai, kaise latest se karna hai, toh aise karna hai, theek hai? So, this was a policy document that was there in 2012. This is not an official document of the government of India, but the people involved in this document preparation are the people like your ex-National Security Advisor, Nandan Nilekani, but the people from your bureaucracy, people from your diplomats, people from your economic front, people from your like chief editor of the Hindu, the people, academia and all, they all prepared this document. People like, we had Shiv Shankar Menon. Who was he? He was your security, NSA, National Security Advisor. Shyam Saran. Who was he? Shyam Saran articles are coming all the time. He was your ex-foreign secretary. Okay? Then we have Pratap Bhanu Mehta, academia, very renowned person. So these kind of people have prepared this policy document. And this policy document has also said one thing. I will read out the line exactly what the document says. But the essence of the document is that NAM in the current scenario is very much relevant. Means NAM in the sense in the current scenario in our foreign policy is very much relevant because we need to maintain our strategic autonomy. And it has given the suggestion also to, in this current scenario, if we need to maintain our strategic autonomy, first India needs to develop its economic and military power. Then only we can maintain our autonomy. Otherwise, the bigger donor will dominate us. So it has talked about the relevance of NAM, but also suggested that, yes, NAM has a relevance. You cannot ignore it. Okay? Rather, it is more important right now because we are tackling, we are dealing with many countries. But at the same time, we also need to develop our economic and your military power. Because unless and until you have that, this money power is very much important. Okay? Money power, that's why China is doing whatever China wants. Okay? CPEC lelo, OBR lelo, whatever. Supporting North Korea lelo, whatever. Okay? So this economic power is very important. So this is what the policy document has also said. I will read out the line. See, India's challenge in NAM, you can write, if you get a question, what are the challenges in following the NAM? You know, you can write, to aim at, first you write what the document says, then I'll explain. To aim at not just being powerful, to aim, matlab India should aim at not just being powerful, but to set new standards for what the powerful must do. Okay? Second thing is, I will explain it, okay? Non-aligned today will require, non-alignment today will require managing complicated coalitions and opportunities. Coalition era, jisko kehte hai na? Complicated coalitions and opportunities in an environment that is not structurally settled. ठीक है, देखो फर्स्ट लाइन दैट यू हैव रिटन इज टू एम नॉट जस्ट बीइंग पावरफुल. वी कैन नॉट ओनली एम फॉर बीइंग पावरफुल बट एट द सेम टाइम वी शुड बी द रूल मेकर्स ऑल्सो. हाउ कैन यू बी द रूल मेकर्स वेन यू बिकम अ इकोनॉमिक पावर, वेन यू बिकम अ मिलिट्री पावर? सो टू मेंटेन नैम फर्स्ट थिंग इज we should be dominant. This is what it is saying. And aaj ke time pe, because now we are dealing with many complicated relations. Say for example, how can you say relationships are complicated on some platform like Tapi? Pakistan ke saath we are doing surgical strike, but on Tapi we are having a peace, whether we try to maintain a peaceful relationship so that gas comes from Turkmenistan, Afghanistan, Pakistan finally to इंडिया. कहाँ आएगी इंडिया में? फजील का, इट्स इन पंजाब, है ना. फ्रॉम वेयर इट विल स्टार्ट? इट विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम गालकिंच इन योर तुर्कमेनिस्तान. ठीक है, पीटी आ रहा है तो सम ऑफ द फैक्ट्स. सो दिस इज हाउ वी आर इन अ लिविंग इन अ सिस्टम वेयर थिंग्स आर वेरी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड. ऑन वन हैंड वी आर सेइंग वी आर द नेबर्स, peaceful coexistence. On the other hand, we are doing surgical strikes, we are doing hot pursuits with Myanmar. Okay? And in the situ way we need it, we need for connecting with ASEAN, we need Myanmar. We are doing hot pursuits also. So that is why it is said that NAM is very much required. Because the system is not like the Cold War, ki do blocks hain. Aaj ke time pe itne loosely blocks hain, you never know. Right now, one example is how complicated systems are now. Right now, your current case that is going on is your Jadhav case. Kulbhushan Jadhav, theek hai? From where was he captured? Iran, theek hai? He was having some business there in Chabahar port. But right now, we say India and Iran very good relationship, but Iran is not speaking even a single word. So this is not a very structured organization. The organizations are very loosely packed depending on their national interest. Because why Iran is not saying anything? Because Iran does not want to annoy Pakistan, one thing. And by doing this, Iran is also creating pressure on India. Don't go very close to GCC, otherwise we will go closer to Pakistan. So this kind of system is there. Okay? On one project we are together, but on the other project we are at loggerheads. So this kind of system situation is there. So in this situation, NAM is your strategic decision making, your autonomy is very important. ठीक है, so never newspaper में जितना पढ़ा ना, नहीं होना चाहिए, ये होना चाहिए, that is one aspect, one side of the story. But the other side of a story is this, that it is still very much relevant. ठीक है, emotions में नहीं बहना. UPSC politically neutral. ठीक है, इट्स नॉट यू आर गोइंग फॉर वोट बैंक पॉलिटिक्स देयर. यू आर टू बिकम अ सिविल सर्वेंट हु हैज टू हैव अ बैलेंस व्यू. ठीक है, नाउ वन वेरी स्मॉल टॉपिक. हाँ, बिकॉज सी टुमारो वी विल स्टार्ट डूइंग नेबरहुड, इंडिया एंड नेबरहुड. ठीक है, बिकॉज दैट इज योर टॉपिक नंबर वन इन द सिलेबस. We'll start doing countries one by one, important countries. Let's begin with Bangladesh because abhi so many new things have happened. Okay, now neighborhood. What is the current scenario in our neighborhood? How is the scenario there? Then only we can discuss about neighborhood. Na, ye thoda sa discuss kar lete. How do you see the current scenario? What kind of situation is prevailing in our neighborhood? See, the situation is very, you can say it's very complicated right now, but somewhat stable. Utni instability bhi nahi hai jitni aapke Syria mein hai, theek hai, ya West Asia mein hai. It is complicated, very complicated. If you see our neighborhood, there are so many problems in our neighborhood. Say for example, first and the foremost problem, we have unresolved maritime and border disputes. Maximum aapke hain पाकिस्तान के साथ, वी हैव विद श्रीलंका, वी हैव विद चाइना. ठीक है, आपका मतलब वी हैव इवन विद नेपाल ऑल्सो देर आर माइन्यूट एरियाज वेयर वी आर हैविंग डिस्प्यूट्स दैट वी विल डिस्कस बिकॉज इट वॉज इन द न्यूज वाई इट वॉज इन द न्यूज वेन वील डू नेपाल वील डू दैट ठीक है सो वी हैव अनरिजॉल्व नेबरहुड देन वॉट इज हैपनिंग रेडिकलाइजेशन इज ऑल्सो ग्रोइंग अक्रॉस द नेबरहुड ठीक है हमें बैलेंस बनाना है इस्लामिक एंड बुद्धिज्म बोथ काइंड ऑफ रेडिकलाइजेशन इस्लामिक इज योर पाकिस्तान अफगानिस्तान मालदीव्स ऑल दीज एरियाज यू आर सीइंग ग्रोइंग रेडिकलाइजेशन यू सी श्रीलंका एंड म्यांमार यू हैव बुद्धिस्ट नेशनलिज्म ग्रोइंग देयर दैट इज ऑल्सो अ प्रॉब्लम देन वी हैव सोशियो कल्चरल सिमिलैरिटीज इन द रीजन सो वी हैव एथनिक कन्फ्लिक्ट्स ऑल्सो ठीक है तमिल इशू इज योर एथनिक कन्फ्लिक्ट देन विद इन इंडिया एंड नेपाल वी हैव मेनी क्रॉस बॉर्डर मैरिजेज एंड ऑल देन वी हैव द इशूज ठीक है सो दोज काइंड ऑफ इशूज देन एथनिक इशूज ग्रेटर नागालैंड एंड ऑल दोज थिंग्स ठीक है नागालैंड ग्रेटर नागालैंड एंड ऑल दोज थिंग्स दैट इज ऑल्सो हैपनिंग देन इन योर नेबरहुड वॉट इज देयर राइट नाउ द सिचुएशन इज अर्लियर वी वर डीलिंग विद वन कंट्री बट नाउ वी आर डीलिंग इन पेयर्स ठीक है अर्लियर इट वॉज ओनली इंडिया डीलिंग विद श्रीलंका बट नाउ चाइना इज ऑल्सो देयर अनदर आउटसाइड फोर्सेज आर देयर देन नॉन स्टेट एक्टर्स देयर रोल हैज ऑल्सो इंक्रीज्ड इन द नेबरहुड अर्लियर इट वॉज नॉट दैट मच आज के टाइम पे नॉन स्टेट एक्टर्स फ्रॉम एवरीवेयर नेपाल से आ जा रहे हैं वी हैव इंसर्जेंट बेसेज इन भूटान ऑल्सो वी हैव इंसर्जेंट बेसेज इन नेपाल इंसर्जेंट बेसेज इन बांग्लादेश सो दीज काइंड ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्सिटीज आर देयर एंड देन इफ वी आर डूइंग इफ वी आर हेल्पिंग देन वी आर लेबल्ड एज बिग ब्रदर We are labeled as big brother, okay? Trust deficit. The main reason of instability in the region is trust deficit. And this trust deficit has been taken advantage by China. That is why China is coming everywhere, okay? Pehle China was not coming, doing any exercise with Nepal, but now it is doing the Sagarmatha thing. Then earlier, our friends like Russia and all, they have never done any exercise with Pakistan. But they have done it. So this kind of outside powers are also having too much of influence in the region. So that is why overall we can say that neighborhood somehow stability is there, but situation is not very easy to deal with the neighborhood. Why are we are discussing this point? Because when we will be dealing with one by one country, so we need to keep all these things in the mind. UPSC's very favorite question is like, what is the importance of this country? What are the challenges in this country? And what could be the future? How can it be further improved? ठीक है तो further improved में scenario ध्यान में रख के we can only talk about. How can it be further improved? तो scenario in this region is this. ठीक है Then current thing is PT is coming. Your Korean thing is happening. Korea में हो रहा है अभी What could be the probable questions in PT with respect to Korean thing? Huh? Geography could be the thing. Then apart from that, third, you might get this question. You will think ये तो science and tech का है, but third is in the news अभी. ठीक है, there is no bifurcation कि IR है तो वो वहाँ नहीं पूछेंगे. Third, what is third? टर्मिनल हाई ऑल्टीट्यूड एरिया डिफेंस सिस्टम ठीक है जो थर्ड का सिस्टम है राइट नाउ थर्ड यूएसए हैज इंस्टॉल्ड इट इन साउथ कोरिया ठीक है तो इट इज टर्मिनल है टर्मिनल मीन्स व्हेन द मिसाइल इज बीइंग शॉट इनिशियली इट कैन नॉट डिटेक्ट इट बट व्हेन इट इज कमिंग डाउन टर्मिनल स्टेज में इट कैन किल द मिसाइल सो दैट इज कॉल्ड terminal high altitude area defense that is their third is in the news then your mother of all bomb that is also in the news mo mother moab so what is that gbu 43 what chemical is used in this these kind of things current last year's question paper if you see current means there were certain issues which were immediately in the current, and at the same time there were certain questions which were 2-3 years back, they were in the news. So back and forth, NAM abhi aaj humne padha. So just see what is current with respect to NAM. What is Russia? Mother, father, sabke paas hai, but abhi jo thing is in the news, we will see that. See, mother of all bombs, why it is called mother of all bombs? It is, you know, what is the weight of it? 10,000 kgs. And it can have the ammunitions of 8,000 kgs. Ordinary bombs have ammunitions of 250 kgs. 250 and 8,000 kgs. And how itna bhari hai, how it is, it cannot be dropped like this. It was like what, they have air dropped it through with the help of parachute. Okay? Special aircraft carrier. And what is so special about this bomb? This bomb, it uses the oxygen in the surrounding so that it can go for higher, like uska jo explosion hota hai, hai na? To uske liye it uses the oxygen in the surrounding. In the other bombs, we have a combination of fuel and oxygen. So these, matlab why it's called a mother bomb. Now you have to be very smart. UPSC is becoming smart, you have to be smarter. If something is there in the news, and a future bureaucrat who has to deal with all those things, they are testing your these skills. ठीक है, आपका हिस्ट्री भी पूछ रहे हैं, करंट भी पूछ रहे हैं, साइंस एंड टेक भी, दे आर आस्किंग यू, इकोनॉमिक्स भी दे आर आस्किंग यू, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ बनानास हैव बीन डिस्कवर्ड लास्ट टाइम दैट वाज देयर अंडमान एंड निकोबार. सो वन ईयर वन वैरायटी ऑफ फ्रॉग, एनी वैरायटी ऑफ एनीथिंग, प्लीज सी इट. यस्टरडेज और डे बिफोर यस्टरडेज हिंदू, वन वैरायटी ऑफ प्लांट हैज बीन डिस्कवर्ड इन योर वेस्टर्न घाट्स. ठीक है, UPSC is very happy to ask you questions which are there with the pictures in the newspapers. Okay? Hornbill was there, they asked you Hornbill festival. They asked you this. Last year, pucha hai Hornbill festival because the bird was once throughout the year, picture aayi thi ek baar, uske baare mein. So, be smart, then only you can beat. Otherwise, 0.5 marks, we are in or out. Okay? So, tomorrow we'll start doing Bangladesh. Huh? Yes, hard powers. Soft. Yes, thanks for reminding. This is for the online students. What is hard power and soft power? Those who want to go can go. Basically, for online, 2 minutes I think video was not working. Those who have I-cards can collect their PT365 society material. Okay? So, hard power is your power, which is basically your power, which is where we use force. Force can be your military force. Force can be your economic force. Economic force is your sanctions. Okay? Jaise we have done, we have used hard economic sanctions on Iran. Okay? Iran mein economic sanctions we have used. In WTO also we used economic sanctions. World Bank also uses economic sanction. That is your hard power. Soft power is the power where we try to persuade a country without using force. Okay? We try to change the decision of the country in our favor without use of force. That is your soft power. Soft power can be your dance, can be your cuisine, can be your medical tourism, Ayush, your space diplomacy, anything can be your Bollywood, your cricket. These are your soft powers. Then hard power plus soft power is equal to your smart power. When we use both the powers, that is called your smart power. And what is your fast power? This is a new term coined with respect to India. Means we are using our smart power in a very fast manner. So that is why it is being used with respect to India. That is your fast power. Soft power has its importance because right now on the global platforms, we are talking about consensus building, we are talking about good governance. So soft power has its importance, but it also has its limitation because it is very time taking. It has no value without hard power. then at the same time, many times our soft power is also taken, misused by the countries. Okay? We are taken as big brother rather than elder brother. And then without hard power, soft power has no power. And then another thing is, in a country like India, especially or developing countries, soft power has a limitation because we have resource crunch. So we, as a developing country, one of the fastest growing economy, we need to have a balance between hard power and soft power, which is your smart power. And this concept was given by Joseph Nye. Theek hai? Samajh aaya? Koi dikkat? India. India ke liye ye term coin. This, we are so vigorously we are interacting with different countries, no? And somewhere we are using hard power, somewhere we are using soft power. In some countries, you know, we are using hard power, like surgical strikes we have done, hot pursuits we have done. At the same time, we are giving 5 billion LOC to Bangladesh also. So we are using all our powers, all our arsenals. Okay? So that is why this term is coined, especially with respect to India. Any doubts? See, NAM talks about your independence. Okay? NAM as an organization, NAM as a principle. There are two things. As an organization, forget it. But as a principle, it also talks about not aligning to anyone. Because when you are aligned to any military power or any superpower, you are being dictated by them. So NAM as a tool of your foreign policy, forget about organization. Okay? So it means you are saying that you are not aligning to anyone. That means you are maintaining your strategic autonomy. Samajh mein aaya? Because dekho, NAM mein what happens is you get confused. NAM as an organization, NAM as a principle. So this is why we have discussed it separately. I hope things are clear. Agar nahi hai to please push lo. Public opinion, like? Track two diplomacy, basically public opinion is, public opinion many times your civil society organizations and all, they deal in public opinion. Okay? Similarly, we have P2P, people to people, G2B, sorry, G2G is your government to government, and a P2P, G2G, B2B, business to business. Okay?